Toyota's Friday Night Rivals pregame show is sponsored by Food City.
And welcome to our Friday Night Rivals pregame show. I'm PJ Johnson, along with sports director Casey Getz. And tonight, we've got one of the best rivalries in the area. We're talking Musket Bowl. Daniel Boone and David Crockett.
Yeah, last year these two played in front of an estimated 8,000-9,000 people in Jonesboro. The atmosphere for that game, second to none. And for those who are part of this rivalry, it's also second to none.
It's just the Washington County Super Bowl. It's, a 365-day, if you're on the top side, if you're on the bottom side, you got to think about it for a whole year. So it's big for your both communities. You know, both schools are going to, get after each other, and it's just a great thing for Washington County.
Is there anybody alive that understands this more than you? You played in it, you coached in it, and you've lived it.
You'll hear from people this week. I've already had calls from old-timers, you remember we owe them down there. They still remember the 74-0 back in 71, you still hear that all the time. So it's one of those things that you never forget, and you always remember the Musket Bowl. If you was part of it, that's one of the games you'll always remember.
Your dad was at David Crockett as well. So what is that like here? I'm sure there's players now, and even Coach Chanley. What's it like where some you go to one school, maybe you're with the other and vice versa?
My dad's on our staff here is our defensive line coach, and he was the head coach down there, I think, from 82 to 85. And, I remember I was just 8 or 9, but I remember then just seeing the atmosphere that it was, and then to have Hayden's played in it from a player on our standpoint, and then being as a coach down there. It's just one of those things where words really can't just describe it, because you're in that one game and you have all this adrenaline and stuff, and then if you're on the other side of it, which I've not been there, I don't know how that would, you'd have to talk to them. That's got to be some type of gut-wrenching, because you played on, for the team that you're with, and then you're on the other school. So it's probably one of those unique, examples.
Last year, the atmosphere for the Musket Bowl, for people that aren't involved in the game, it was unbelievable. I know you've been in many of them. Where did last year's atmosphere rank for you?
Absolutely. Number one, we had to take a police escort down there. We wouldn't have got in. And, it was just a great, both communities, both stands were packed. It was for the conference, for the championship. And it came down to the last play of the game, which is the way it should be.
This year's been tough on you guys. It's injury-wise. You lost your best player, Charlie Cole, and you had some other players nicked up. I know you say that's just football, but somewhere you must think there was a black cat in my life or a broken mirror, right?
But injuries is part of football, but we have lost, we lost three of our top players, offense, defense, and then up our offensive lineman. Chandler Masters is one that really nobody knows. It happened before the season started, our first scrimmage, and he had ACL tear and was one of our top linemen up there. So, losing all those players, I think it really helped some kids get better quick for us. We had to plug some kids into some positions that we knew they would be there, but not at the time we wanted them to be there. So we had some growing pains there. But when we were 1-4, everybody had kind of written us off. That's part of football too. If you're winning, they're with you, and if you're losing, they're just kind of they don't know. But now we're 4-4, 1-3 in a row, and we're playing the best we've been playing all year.
How much confidence does your team have right now after reeling off three straight wins to get back to 500 on the season?
I think we're really playing with a lot of confidence, especially in a line of scrimmage. That's where games are won, and we're playing as well as we have played up front in a long time as far as doing what you're supposed to do. And we've just had a lot of different kids lead us by example. And, Devon coming back against DB and being back with 3 or 4 games, he's kind of getting the mainstay over there on defense far as that goes. And just getting out there and doing what you're supposed to do, and just have fun doing it. We built ourselves in a situation where we know if we win out, we're going to host a playoff game. And 4 or 5 weeks ago, if you'd have said that, you probably would be saying you're crazy. But our kids have really, really played well the last 3 weeks.
As an old quarterback, you've been around quarterbacks. What's your impressions of Cade Larkins of Crockett?
I'll talk about his arm and talk about it, but just the thing with him that really impresses me more than anything is just his pocket presence. Nothing really seems to rattle him. He can beat you with his arm. He can move. I mean, a lot of people don't think he can move as well as he can. He can move a lot. But I think him just being another coach on the field, they can get him in and out of plays. And just a great, Kurt Phillips is one of the top quarterbacks that I've coached against here. and Larkins would be right up there as far as that caliber with him. As far as that goes, being the two of the top quarterbacks that we've had to face here.
It's games like this, though, that keep high school football so special and make Friday night so special, don't you?
Absolutely. You know, you got your big rivalries. That, you know, you really don't see that a whole lot anymore as far as in a lot of either one's really one-sided or dominated as far as that goes. But I think high school football, you know, you look at us and Crockett, DB and Science Hill, you know, like the South DB is a big rivalry, but they don't play anymore. So, you know, there's another one that would be that. But those two right there, I would say, are the two top high school rivals in this area in football.
Now, up next, we're going to sit down with some members of the David Crockett football team as they try to bounce back from their first loss of the season.
It's track month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City.
19 Tracks, $15,995. 19 Equinox, $20,995. 19 Blazer, $26,995. 20 Traverse, $29,995. 20 Tahoe, $42,995.
Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
It's tailgating season. Make yours a big hit with any of these favorites from Food City.
Like deli fresh fried chicken, made in-store salads, and more only at Food City.
Value every day, Food City.
At Food City, fresh means our beef is ground in the store several times a day, time-stamped with the hour it was ground. Just one of the many reasons we say, start fresh with Food City.
When the sun comes up, it's go time, whether at work or at play, on the field or off. Life doesn't stop, and neither should you. So when you get injured, Holston Medical Group is here to get you back on your feet. Our orthopedic and sports medicine physicians deliver quality care that exceeds expectations, specializing in non-surgical techniques and minimally invasive procedures to get you back in the game fast. Now with convenient walk-in access in Bristol at Sapling Grove, we are HMG, your doctor, your family, your health partner for life.
At this time in your life, would you like a little extra attention when you feel you need it? Hi, I'm Alina Haynes. At Colonial Hill Retirement Center, we have supportive services to provide the extra attention you deserve. Keep yourself healthy and fit in our exercise classes. Need medication reminders? We can do that. Need a little help to look your best? We can do that. Our friendly staff will help keep you at your very best. Call 282-6903 or just drop by.
It's track month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City.
19 Crew Cab All-Star, $11,000 off. 19 Extended Cab All-Star, $12,000 off. 19 Light Duty Extended Cab, $12,000 off. 19 2500 Duramax Diesel, $13,771 off.
Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
David Crockett enters tonight's Musket Bowl, coming off their first loss of the season. It's the first regular season loss for the Pioneers under second-year head coach Hayden Chandler.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how the Pioneers respond to that loss against Tennessee High. Motivation, though, should not be a problem against your biggest rival. It's a game and atmosphere that is rare at the high school level, the Musket Bowl, and the players know how lucky they are to be a part of it.
It was awesome. You know, the community was great. The Pioneer Nation showed out. The atmosphere was great, so just being able to play in a game like that, especially in high school, like you don't get that very often, so it was a great experience.
It was great.
Goodman Jewelers has skilled craftsmen that can bring your dream to reality. Goodman Jewelers, downtown Abingdon.
We've got the new Lexus to fit your life
and your style.
Drive a new RX 350 for only $389 a month.
Nothing else feels quite like a Lexus.
And nothing else feels like the buying experience at Lexus of Kingsport, where our commitment to you sets us apart.
Welcome to Express Checkout. On friendshipcars.com, you can view inventory from all our locations. Get the best pricing and choose your payment without the hassle. Get an instant cash offer for your trade-in. Research and select a protection package that works best for you. Take advantage of all Express Checkout has to offer and be in and out in under 30 minutes. That's it. It's that easy. Instant pricing and Express Checkout from friendshipcars.com. Start your new car shopping experience today.
Thank you.
Pacific noon kickoff, Saturday at 11 Eastern on Fox and the Fox Sports app.
As the lazy days of summer give way to the cool, crisp breezes of autumn, the time comes for a vibrant array of colors, cozy jackets, and great saving at Food City.
This week's save on Food City ground chuck. $2.99 per pound, 3 pounds or more. Strawberries, buy one, get one free. Deli chicken salad or chicken tenders, $5.99 per pound and more. Only at Food City.
In Jonesboro, you can feel the fabric of stories deeply woven.
Welcome back to our Food City pregame show. There's always a lot on the line when David Crockett and Daniel Boone play, and this year's no different. The winner of tonight's game likely gets a home playoff game, so it's huge.
It is a big deal. David Crockett, 7-1 Pioneers. They won the Musket Bowl last year. Get this, they have not won back-to-back Musket Bowl since 2001-2002. Pioneers averaging 39 points a game, giving up 18 points a night. Daniel Boone, they're 4-4. The Trailblazers, though, have won three straight, averaging 19 points a game. But during their three-game winning streak, they're averaging 34 points per game. Defensively, Daniel Boone giving up 24 points per game. Well, we've set the table for tonight's Musket Bowl. The only thing left to do before we play the game is make some predictions. The Prep Picks crew is on deck with their predictions this week.
But first, we want to say thank you to Food City for being the sponsor of our pregame show.
Hi, I'm Steve Smith with Food City. It's great to partner with WCYB to sponsor the Friday Night Rivals pregame show. You know, football in our communities is so important as families gather to root on their home team, to watch either in person or to watch on TV. And we're excited to be a sponsor. And don't forget, Food City is your tailgating headquarters.
All trophies and plaques for WCYB's Friday Night Rivals are provided by Eddie's Trophies and Gift Shop in Bristol. Eddie's Trophies also offers medals, plaques, acrylics, glass, and crystal pieces for your business, school, or sports team. That's Eddie's Trophy and Gift Shop, online at eddiestrophies.com.
When the sun comes up, it's go time, whether at work or at play, on the field or off. Life doesn't stop, and neither should you. So when you get injured, Holston Medical Group is here to get you back on your feet. Our orthopedic and sports medicine physicians deliver quality care that exceeds expectations, specializing in non-surgical techniques and minimally invasive procedures to get you back in the game fast. Now with convenient walk-in access in Bristol at Sapling Grove, we are HMG, your doctor, your family, your health partner for life.
When you're driving a legend, nothing gets in your way, work or play. The tough built in the USA Tundra, the rugged Tacoma, and the ready for adventure 4Runner. For over 50 years, Toyota has built the best trucks money can buy. Trucks that legends are made of. Now, during Toyota Truck Month, get $1,750 cash back on any new 2019 Tacoma. Or lease a new Tacoma 4x4 double cab for $219 a month. Drive a legend. Toyota, let's go places.
David Crockett enters tonight's Musket Bowl, coming off their first loss of the season. Now, this is their first regular season loss for the Pioneers under second-year head coach Hayden Chandler.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see, PJ, how they respond to a loss against Tennessee High. Motivation, though, should not be a problem against your biggest rival, the Musket Bowl. It's a game, an atmosphere that is rare at the high school level. The players know how lucky they are to be a part of it.
It was awesome. You know, the community was great. The Pioneer Nation showed out. The atmosphere was great, so just being able to play in a game like that, especially in high school, like, you don't get that very often, so it was a great experience.
It was great. I mean, there's a bunch of fans I haven't seen. Like, it was packed, you know. I seen a picture on Facebook. I mean, the whole campus was full, so hopefully we can have that this year again.
What is it that brings out the emotion in that game? Is it because these two schools are so close or because they've been playing for so long?
I think they've been playing for so long, to be honest. I mean, I've been playing with Mark, Micah, and all them, John, since I was like fifth, sixth grade, and just playing together their last year was just amazing. You know, winning that Musket, there was nothing like it.
You know, it's a big rivalry, and you know, we know a lot of kids over there. We only live, you know, it's cross county, but Musket Bowl, you know, days back, long time, and a lot of history, and you know, it's a competitive game, and it's going to be a great atmosphere, so looking forward to it.
Last week was something new for you guys. This will be the first time you've actually come off a loss and have to play a game, because you made it all through last year until the playoffs and the season ended. How is the team going to react to that?
We're going to learn from it, and it's only going to make us stronger, I think. You know, we can take everything we learned from that game and just put it in the rest of the season. Hopefully it motivates us a little bit.
I think we use that motivation. I mean, it's not like we didn't play hard. It's just maybe they played a slight harder, you know. it's just one of those things that, you know, you can't really help. You can just hope and play them again or just build on it.
As a senior leader, how do you guys make sure everybody turns the pages and dwelling on that loss and they're focused on Daniel Boone this week?
And we just got to get the team together, you know, captains, get the team together and make sure everybody's head up and get ready to practice, because we seniors have two games left, guaranteed, so we can't just be stuck on that one loss.
Your offense is pretty much wide open and it's just made for a quarterback like you. How much fun is it to play in this offense?
It's awesome having athletes around me like Dante and Prince and Mason and Eric and Ronquil, and you know, all these guys just make it a lot of fun. Coaches do a great job of using our athletes and getting them the ball, just letting them make plays, so it's been a lot of fun.
How about for you as a wide receiver, when you got a quarterback like 16 throwing you the ball, what kind of connection do you guys have and how much fun is it playing with him on Friday nights?
I mean, it's amazing, you know, there's no other quarterback like 16, you know, he just puts it where it needs to be almost every other time, so. I mean, he's a great football player. He's a great person out of football.
This offense is tailor-made for you, too. I mean, it takes one guy to throw it, but it takes a couple of guys to catch it as well. So it's got to be so much fun.
It is fun. You know, me, Prince, Colley, Eric, Mason, you know, those guys, I mean, they're great football players also. So it's just fun watching them make plays. And, you know, I make plays and watching Kay throw the ball to them. I mean, it's just fun.
What's this season been like for you? Has it been tough just even on weekends? You're going somewhere, looking at other college programs, talking to coaches. You probably stay football busy 24/7. What's it like? What's a day in the life of Kay like?
I love it, and I love football, so it's been a great year for me. I'm trying to soak it all in. You know, you only get senior year once. So at the same time, you know, I'm keeping straight with academics, and I'm just keeping my head down studying, so. But it's been a lot of fun being able to go through this whole process and see all these places, so I've been loving it.
It's been hard, though, to kind of keep that balance of staying in the present but also looking ahead to the future, because I'm sure that's on your mind, you know, where you're going to play next year. Has that been a balancing act?
It's just like any high schooler, though. Like, everybody's figuring out where they want to go to college right now. It's just a matter of I'm playing football at the next level, so it's not really been hard. It's just something you have to do, and I'm enjoying it because not everybody gets this opportunity.
Playing on TV, you guys did that earlier this season against Science Hill. What was it like after the game, whether watching the replay or just talking to people around the area, being on TV? What was that like?
I mean, it was amazing. You know, saying I got to watch the game on TV, I was like, what? Watch it on TV? So, I mean, hopefully I watch the Science Hill game on TV after our game, the Science Hill game. I got to watch it on YouTube because it was recorded. So hopefully I get to watch the Muscle Bowl again on it. It was great. It was fun.
It's awesome. You know, people come up to you and say, hey, I saw you playing on TV, and being able to, like, we recorded it at our house, so I got to go back and watch it. So it's just cool, you know, having an announcer say your name and just seeing replays. It's like watching a college football game. It's a lot of fun.
And when we come back, we're going to go inside the numbers on tonight's game between the Pioneers and the Trailblazers.
It's tailgating season. Make yours a big hit with any of these favorites from Food City.
Like deli fresh fried chicken, made in-store salads, and more. Only at Food City.
Value every day, Food City.
At Food City, fresh means our beef is ground in the store several times a day. Time-stamped with the hour it was ground. Just one of the many reasons we say, start fresh with Food City.
All trophies and plaques for WCYB's Friday Night Rivals are provided by Eddie's Trophies and Gift Shop in Bristol. Eddie's Trophies also offers medals, plaques, acrylics, glass, and crystal pieces for your business, school, or sports team. That's Eddie's Trophy and Gift Shop, online at eddiestrophies.com.
Welcome into Prep Picks. Casey Guest alongside Heather Williams and Steve Wilmoth of ESPN Tri-Cities, tricitiesports.com. Last week, we all went 1-4. Can I speak for the group, say we're embarrassed and ashamed of ourselves?
I was so embarrassed I had to change my picture on the picks because I needed a new mojo.
All right, well, nowhere to go but up this week. Heather, we're going to start with you. Southwest Virginia, good game. Castlewood at J.I. Burton, pair of 5-2 teams going at it.
Yeah, and how cool is it to see Castlewood kind of in the mix? It's been a while since this program has been up there. J.I. Burton, though, is just playing some really good football. And at this point in the season, this is when traditionally they start hitting their stride and really make their push towards the playoffs. So it's really hard for me to pick against Burton at this point.
Yeah, my friend Chris Lark has the Blue Devils at 5-2 in his first year, coming off their first win over Lebanon since 1987. But Heather's right. J.I. Burton, after dropping its first two games, has won five straight for an average of about 38 points per game. Two common opponents, too. My favorite thing, Twin Springs and Honeaker. Castlewood beat both by a combined 6 points. Meanwhile, J.I. Burton by a combined 88. Those are data points I can't ignore. I will go with the Raiders.
88's more than 60. I'm going with you, J.I. Burton. Steve, Abingdon is at Ridgeview. The Falcons off a bye week. Ridgeview bounced back from that loss against Union. Beat John Battle last week. Just a big game in the Mountain 7 district.
Well, I certainly hope that we can bounce back from our Union debacle as well as Ridgeview did last week and ride that Ridgeview train to win on this one.
How interesting is that whole conference gotten with Y Central getting the big upset last week? It's still back open. Ridgeview has a chance to win that, and I think that they take a huge step towards doing that over Abingdon. They both, Ridgeview and Union, still have to play Abingdon this season. I think Ridgeview takes a step towards winning that conference by winning this week.
I like the Wolfpack at home. They get a win and move on and continue their quest for the number one seed in Class 2. Heather, Tennessee High, they can wrap up a conference championship this week if they beat Cherokee at the Stone Castle.
And how big was their win last week? I guess we should all apologize for not picking that last week. I'm going to go Tennessee High.
Now, the Vikings can wrap up the first seed out of Region 1-5A and all that home playoff stuff that comes with it with the win. Hopefully they won't overlook Cherokee, even if Cherokee is without their quarterback. We don't really know his status, but I'll stick with Tennessee High. Congratulations. Already got their first conference championship in 10 years.
Yeah, the Vikings, 7 wins in a row. That loss to Dobbins-Bennett was a long, long time ago. I think Tennessee High is going to make it 8 straight and get this win over Cherokee. Steve, Friday night you'll be at J. Fred Johnson Stadium, Science Hill, Dobbins-Bennett. Need we say more?
Need we say more? The game of the year in Kingsport for sure, in Johnson City for sure. Dobbins-Bennett coming in, having won 10 straight games, their longest streak since 2002. I just don't think there's going to be enough big plays, splash plays made by Science Hill against that very stingy Dobbins-Bennett defense. And Dobbins-Bennett a win, and even a Science Hill loss and 2 Farragut wins at home throughout the playoffs as well. So I came prepared tonight. I'm making up for last year. Remember that?
Yes, I do.
Roll trap.
Yep. Well, nobody knows Dobbins-Bennett better than Steve, and I'm 4 games back in the standings, so I'm definitely not going against him in this one. I'm picking Dobbins-Bennett as well.
Indians are rolling. No one's been within 20 points of them all season long. I think that continues. Dobbins-Bennett gets to 9-0. And finally, our Friday night rivals game this week is the Musket Bowl. David Crockett and Daniel Boone. Heather, David Crockett for the first time under Hayden Chandley coming off a regular season loss.
Yeah, and it'll be interesting to see how they bounce back. How much do I love this rivalry? And there are some great rivalries around here, but what's so cool about this rivalry? You go to practice during the week, and the two teams are playing each other's fight songs to get each other riled up. They don't like each other. It's a great rivalry. It's going to be an amazing atmosphere at Boone. But I just think Crockett has too much firepower. I think that they will take the Musket once again.
You know, Crockett last week and that's lost at Tennessee High, Vikings kind of hit them in the mouth a little bit physically, and Crockett really didn't like it. Boone held up against Dobbins-Bennett from a physical standpoint as well as any team I've seen this year. If they had Charlie Cole in the backfield healthy, I might be leaning towards Boone in this one. Without him, I don't think there's enough physicality there to overcome the athleticism of David Crockett. So I'll stick with the Pioneers. And how many years has it been since the Pioneers went back-to-back on Muskets?
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how the Pioneers respond to getting, as Steve said, punched in the mouth like they did against Tennessee High. We'll see maybe a determined David Crockett team as they try and reset for a playoff run here. I'll take the Pioneers as well to get a win in the Musket Bowl. Well, Steve and Heather, thank you so much for joining me. You can see all your scores and highlights coming up on Friday Night Huddle.
Kids' small airways are easily blocked.
Even by respiratory illnesses that would be minor in an adult. That's why our ER pediatricians work 24/7, so families can breathe easier. We're Niswonger Children's Hospital.
We've got the new Lexus to fit your life.
And your style.
Drive a new ES350 for only $369 a month.
Nothing else feels quite like a Lexus.
And nothing else feels like the buying experience at Lexus of Kingsport, where our commitment to you sets us apart.
Yeah, let's go.
Connection by Jersey Mike's. Be a sub above.
Colonial Hill Retirement Center has everything you need to really enjoy life. Hi, I'm Alina Haynes.
At Colonial Hill Retirement Center, you choose how to spend your time. We have trips for shopping, sightseeing, concerts, and theaters. Join a good friend for dinner. Enjoy quiet moments in your own apartment. You can entertain family and friends, and we'll do the work. Make life fun. Call 282-6903 or just drop by.
Welcome to Express Checkout. On FriendshipCars.com, you can view inventory from all our locations. Get the best pricing and choose your payment without the hassle. Get an instant cash offer for your trade-in. Research and select a protection package that works best for you. Take advantage of all Express Checkout has to offer and be in and out in under 30 minutes. That's it. It's that easy. Instant pricing and Express Checkout from FriendshipCars.com. Start your new car shopping experience today.
Kids' veins are harder to find,
so it's more challenging to insert an IV or draw blood. Thankfully, we have lots of practice finding small veins, and that can mean less poking. We're Niswonger Children's Hospital.
Tonight's School Spotlight is brought to you by your local Toyota dealer.
From the first time you meet Terry Adcock, you can just feel the love and compassion he has for people. He's always smiling and laughing. Adcock has been an important part of Daniel Boone Athletics. He's been the football program's PA announcer for nearly a dozen years.
It's all about the kids. It's not about me. It's anything I can do.
He's also been behind the microphone for almost every other sport at the school.
It just feels good to be a part of the community. You just feel part of a family when you come here and you be a part of the athletics or anything else going on here as well.
Adcock and his family are a much deeper part of the community. Adcock lost his young son 6 years ago and his brother in 2010. The family created the Phil Foundation, in which they help families dealing with a medical crisis. Nearly 100 families have benefited from their willingness to serve.
The love that people showed us, we try to show that to other people. So, like I said, just the community has loved on me so much, so things like this are so easy for me because it's the whole do unto others, and they've done that to us.
Behind every Food City meat and seafood counter is a highly trained, certified butcher that can offer free meal prep, including over 30 different marinades and seasonings to help you craft the perfect dinner. In fact, you'll be so impressed with our butchers, you'll be asking yourself, what can't they do?
I bet he'd be great at cleaning.
Okay, well, maybe not that. But at Food City, our butchers make almost everything better.
More athletic, more refined, more sport, more utility, more performance, more traction, more confidence. Toyota has taken RAV4, the best-selling SUV in America, and redefined what an SUV can be. Introducing the completely redesigned Toyota RAV4. Now get 1.9 financing for 60 months on a new RAV4, or a low-mileage lease on this RAV4 LE for just $199 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
What can you find? Places to unwind, places you can share, and places just to, well, stand and stare. Maybe it's time for you to visit a very special place called Ana.
Need some real FaceTime with your family? With phones off, forks up, and a bountiful buffet, connect with your family today by bringing them to Shoney's. Come in for your favorites and save room for hot fudge cake. Let's eat at Shoney's.
Your home is the heart of your family. At Scott Britton Construction, we're honored to help make that dream a reality. Whether it's your first house, a home for your growing family, or your retirement dream, let us help you with your most important investment. We ensure every home is perfectly constructed from beginning to end. Quality craftsmanship and superior custom is our priority. Visit us at scottbrittonconstruction.com for more.
Friday Night Rivals, driven by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
And welcome to Nathan Hale Stadium, Daniel Boone High School, for the annual matchup.
the Musket Bowl. This game has been played since 1971. Daniel Boone High School and David Crockett High School. As always, P.J. Johnson along with Sports Director Casey Getz. And Casey, when you talk about rivalries in the Tri-Cities region, they really don't get any more fierce than this.
They don't. The Musket Bowl is just an awesome game. Daniel Boone has led this series, P.J., 35-13. They have split each of the last 4 years. David Crockett has not won back-to-back Musket Bowl since 2001-2002. They can do that tonight if they pull off a win after winning last year.
Now both teams are already on the field for the opening coin toss. This game really, Casey, sets down a matchup of one of the state's great quarterbacks.
Cade Larkins, senior for David Crockett, closing in on the all-time career passing record for the state of Tennessee. He's under 900 yards away from getting that record. So we're getting ready for the national anthem here. David Crockett, they won the toss and they deferred to the second half, so Daniel Boone will start with the ball here tonight.
Edition of our national anthem here at Daniel Boone High School. We're ready for some football. As we kind of talked about earlier, this is going to be a showcase tonight for the David Crockett quarterback, who is in search of the all-time record for passing yardage in Tennessee. That record is 11,122 yards, held by Kyle Aiken, set back in his career from 2011-2014. That is a lot of yards, Casey, any way you look at it.
It really is, and Cade Larkins has an outstanding career so far for David Crockett. You know, he's guaranteed two more games in the regular season and about 99.9% guaranteed at least one playoff game. So you look at it, he has probably at least three games to get just under 900 yards. So you don't have to be a math major to figure out if he can average about 300 yards a game over the next three games, he should be able to get the record. Now, you might not be able to see on your TV, but it is raining now right here tonight. You know, obviously, when it's slick like that, the ball, the receivers, you know, Jeremy Jenkins, we talked to Daniel Boone coach earlier this week. He said the receivers know where they're going on a slick field. The defensive backs do not. So he may think to tend the receivers, the passing game might have a more of an advantage because they know where they're going.
I was with Dave Dirks earlier, and he told me the downsloping looked good. Right now it's sloping off my shoes. We're getting a little of this rain. But we've had a terrific season of dry weather, so I guess we're due a few raindrops, Casey. We're ready for the kickoff. Googe will kick it off. And it's just a little squib kick. And Boone will just down it on the 35-yard line where their offense will take over. Now, this Daniel Boone offense is entirely different than one that started the year, Casey, because of injuries.
Yeah, Charlie Cole, their star running back, he got injured in the second game of the season. So right now, they're kind of running back by committee. Joe Jones leading the way. Got Caleb Worley at quarterback for Daniel Boone as well. But Charlie Cole, their star running back, got broke his arm in the Greenville game, the second game of the season, has not played since then. They're hoping to maybe get him back come playoff time.
This David Crockett defense hoping to play a little better than they did last week against Tennessee High. They've been fired up about that. We start off with just a little quarterback keeper by Caleb Worley for a gain off the left side.
for Daniel Boone, the best defense for them is their offense. They want to be able to have, you know, their offense on the field. This David Crockett defense, you got a lot of guys playing both sides of the ball. Tony Davis, we saw him earlier this season, had a great game against Science, so big number 58. Let's see if he can get some penetration at the line of scrimmage for the Pioneers.
Prince Colley in that defensive backfield. Of course, he's a standout on offense as well. A lot of colleges like him on the defensive side of the ball. So Worley, second down and about six. Be a handoff to his running back. Nowhere to go there as Brendan Blair was tackled in the backfield.
By big number 58, Tony Davis there. He is a whale of a defender for David Crockett. Again, if he has a good game tonight, that just does so much for the David Crockett defense. He was a force. Science Hill could not stop Davis in that game we did back in week two. If he gets going, watch out for this David Crockett defense.
So about a third down and seven now for Daniel Boone High School. Trailblazers on their opening move. It'll be a little rollout pass. And it's going to end up being a quarterback keeper. And he breaks a couple of tackles, and he'll be close to a first down. But I think he's going to be just short as Worley evaded one tackler, but the last guy got it.
Yeah, there are a couple of defenders for David Crockett that had a good chance here. Check out the Toyota replay. You see one go flying in right here. Worley does a good job breaking some tackles, but he is going to be, looks like he's going to be just a little bit short of the first down.
Just about a yard short, according to the placement there by the officials. See what they elect to do.
Looks like the offense is going to stay on the field here.
They're going to go for it. This is a rivalry game. They mean business. Boone taking a chance with the ball just short of the 45-yard line.
Let's see if they try and get him to jump off sides here.
Oh, they'll work. It's going to be the quarterback, and he's going to get that first down. Caleb Worley with a good second effort, and Boone keeps the drive alive.
That's a big statement there by Jeremy Jenkins to go for it on fourth down, trusting his offense to get a yard, and they do behind Caleb Worley. So far, PJ, they've run four plays. Three of them have been Worley runs.
Your Toyota replay, look at Worley. Just keep his balance with the left hand down to get that first down. So first down as we approach the 50-yard line, just short of the 50, about 2 yards short of that. Boone very patient. As Casey said, they want to run the clock down, eat as much clock as they can. And they're going to eat some clock this time by jumping off sides.
Yeah, get a false start right there. About half the line went on one. The other half is waiting to hear number two. There's Larry Hutchinson, our referee. In fact, PJ, this is the same crew we had last week at the Greenville-Elizabethan game. We get a lot of airtime.
And the referees want us to pass along, if anyone is interested in being a referee, contact these guys. They always need new referees. So Worley in the backfield. This time he's going to be corralled by a couple of those Pioneers that were out paying a visit there.
Yeah, you see David Crockett's defense, some good penetration up front. Tony Davis takes the ball carrier, and Worley that's left behind for the rest of the guys there to get Mr. Worley.
And we'd like to welcome all our viewers from Facebook Live tonight. If you're watching on the internet, as always, we appreciate the good folks at Champion Chevrolet for sponsoring our Facebook Live coverage. Worley, another quarterback keeper, this time off tackle, and he'll gain a couple, but it's going to bring us up to about a third down and three.
Third down and 13.
And 13.
You know, Daniel Boone so far have not put the ball in the air yet. And that's the thing. They get that penalty on first and 10. Really puts them behind the sticks here. Their meat and potatoes is the ground game. Not so much passing here. So now third and 13. Obvious passing down for Daniel Boone. Let's see what they draw up here. I'd expect something safe. Maybe a wide receiver screen. Maybe even a screen from the running back.
Three receivers split to the left. Worley barking out signals. Looks around. Scrambles. Looks like Worley's going to keep it, but he's going to be corralled in the backfield. Yeah, probably a pickup of about a half yard to a yard.
Does Prince Colley, they got him. Here's our keys to the game for David Crockett. Play physical. They kind of got punched in the mouth last week by Tennessee. I handle adversity. First regular season loss for the Pioneers under second-year head coach Hayden Chanley. For Daniel Boone, control the ball. They've done that so far. Avoid turnovers. You can't give extra possessions to this high-powered Pioneers offense.
So Daniel Boone comes on. Morehouse will punt it away. Dangerous returner here in Hackler. He's going to take the punt and fumble it, and Boone is going to recover it. Daniel Boone with the first big play of the ball game. Casey, you talked about the rain. That was evident. That play deflected. It went right through Hackler's hands. Yeah. We'll see it on the replay.
Yeah, that's a mistake there by Hackler right there.
Right through the wicket.
And that's a big break for Daniel Boone. As an underdog, that's what you need right there. You need to make some breaks.
Austin Cunningham there with the recovery for Boone.
And now all of a sudden, a quick change of possession here. Daniel Boone punts the ball. They think they're going to have to put the defense on the field. The offense, now they get great field position. PJ, they're knocking on the red zone here.
Looks like we've got a break on the field, so it's time for us to take a break as well. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
When you're driving a legend, nothing gets in your way, work or play. The tough built-in the USA Tundra, the rugged Tacoma, and the ready-for-adventure 4Runner. For over 50 years, Toyota has built the best trucks money can buy. Trucks that legends are made of. Now, during Toyota Truck Month, get $1,750 cash back on any new 2019 Tacoma. Or lease a new Tacoma 4x4 double cab for $219 a month. Drive a legend. Toyota, let's go places.
We talked about the rain. Let's go down to the sidelines and Olivia Bailey to check about how bad it is. Olivia?
Yeah, PJ, we're feeling every bit of this rain. It's just a steady downpour here. That hasn't stopped the fans from coming out. They came prepared with umbrellas and ponchos, but these teams are realizing how much of an effect this might have on this game. I've seen Daniel Boone. We're here on the sidelines there, and they've got their they've got everybody in just kind of running some practice throws here and just making sure everyone's ready as this rain continues to fall down here.
All right, Olivia, thank you very much. Daniel Boone now on offense, first down. Hand up the middle. Brendan Blair again with the handoff. Good gaining, a good yardage there, Casey.
Yeah, we'll see with this David Crockett defense. They had a good stand there on that first possession there, but have to get back on the field. Their own end zone is quickly approaching them in their shadows here as this ball is now inside the 20-yard line as we're inside the Toyota red zone.
Worley. From the shotgun. Worley hands it off. Big hole on the right side. And going down close to the goal line is Blair, but he stopped just short.
Really nice run there by Brennan Blair all the way down inside the 5-yard line. It's going to be a first and goal for the Trailblazers.
You see Blair following his blockers, huge hole, and he almost gets in for the first score of the game. So it'll be first down for the Trailblazers. We are in the Toyota red zone. Daniel Boone loves that as they try to draw first blood tonight. 5:58 left here in the first. Boone capitalizing on a mistake by Crockett. This is Worley. Nothing funny about this as Worley takes it over the right side and scores. I'm sorry, that was Blair in at quarterback.
A little wildcat there.
A little wildcat.
Yeah, for Brennan Blair in for the 2-yard touchdown, and Daniel Boone on the board first, PJ.
So Jamie Jenkins pulling out a little wildcat action to get his team on the board as Blair takes it in. Jenkins on for the extra point. Good vantage point there.
I think David Crockett was offsides there on that extra point attempt.
So Daniel Boone has dominated this first quarter, keeping the ball almost the entire time. Chains of possession on a punt and has changed this ball game. And now Jenkins will try to add one more.
And you saw Daniel Boone declining the penalty, so they're going to leave it right there and kick it from the same position.
And Jenkins puts it up and through the middle. And Daniel Boone leads the Musket Bowl 7-0 over David Crockett. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
At Colonial Hill Retirement Center, you'll have all the comforts of home. Hi, I'm Alina Haynes. Colonial Hill Retirement Center has a 24-hour staff, an elegant full-service dining room, and housekeeping to keep things neat and clean. Don't worry about repairs and maintenance. Our staff will take care of everything. Like to entertain with family and friends? We can help you with that. You just relax and enjoy life. Call 282-6903 or just drop by.
And welcome back to the Musket Bowl, everyone. We're at Daniel Boone High School tonight. This game's been played since 1971. But Casey Crockett is trying to do something tonight they haven't done in a while. We had two in a row.
David Crockett has not won back-to-back Musket Bowls since 2001 and 2002. That last scoring drive for Daniel Boone after the muff punt there was three plays, 24 yards, and Brendan Blair got all 24 yards for Daniel Boone, took 2:03 off the clock. Of course, you had that with your first possession that they had, and Daniel Boone able to take off almost half, more than half of the first quarter clock here.
That's the game plan for Boone, of course, is to control the ball and eat the clock. They don't want this explosive offense on that Crockett has on the field any more than they can be. So Boone will kick off. Jenkins will boot it away. Short kick. It's going to be returned by Crockett. Not going very far as he's hit hard at the 30-yard line in case.
You see Daniel Boone fired up here, so we'll take a look at the David Crockett offense. It all starts with Cade Larkins, number 16. Again, he's just under 900 yards away from being the all-time career passing leader in the state of Tennessee for quarterbacks, but he has Dante Hackler, Prince Colley, Mason Britton to throw the ball to, a plethora of receivers for this David Crockett offense.
So Larkins will operate out of the shotgun, a little spread formation here for Crockett. Three receivers to the left. Larkin looks around. Taking his time. He'll put it to the air. And that's Britton out here with a good gain of about five.
You're going to see primarily shotgun from David Crockett. If you ever see Larkins under center, usually that means he's going to run the ball out as a sneak. Here's the Daniel Boone defense. Devon White, the linebacker in the middle, he missed the first couple games of the season for the Trailblazers. He is their quarterback of the defense. Watch your 14 be around the ball all night long.
A little different formation this time from Crockett. Man in motion. Be a handoff to that man. That's Dante Hackler over the right side. And he'll get a couple. So they brought Hackler from his receiver into motion. Little jet sweep, Casey.
You want to get your playmakers the ball any way they can. And you notice so far, David Crockett, they're using every inch of this grass. They're going sideline to sideline. They want to make you defend every inch of this field.
We saw Crockett earlier in the year against Sines Hill, and they were lethal on the little slant pass. Toppers couldn't stop it all night. We haven't seen it yet.
Just two plays so far, you know, also the weather conditions could be a factor in that as well, but I'm sure we'll see that to Colley and Hackler here very soon.
The Larkins on a little rollout. He'll throw out here. That's Hackler trying to avoid tacklers and getting the first down. Good job by Hackler.
Yeah, Hackler, he caught that ball short of the first down marker there, but able to make some yards after the catch. You take a look here at the Toyota replay. Hackler coming in motion, makes a nice catch and lose a couple tackles right there and gets the first down. That's big for this Pioneer offense after giving up that opening touchdown there after the turnover. You want to get a first down, get settled in offensively. David Crockett's doing that so far.
Larkin's spreading the ball around so far. Champion Chevrolet, first down. Here we go with Larkins. Solo in the backfield from the shotgun. This time he's going to slip the ball, just slipped out of his hand. Are they calling that a pass or a fumble?
I would think that would have to be a...
They're calling it a fumble. The ball clearly slipped out of Larkin's hand, but it looked like it went forward.
Yeah, I mean, it looked like he was throwing the ball. I'd like to see a replay here. Take a look at the replay here. All right, looks like that just slipped out of his hand. That is clearly an incomplete pass. That is a bad call by this officiating crew.
Nevertheless, it'll be Daniel Boone's ball. First down, just short of the 40-yard line. Here comes Blair. A little sweep left.
Again, let's go back to that.
Got a really tight shot of it here.
Called a fumble, and he clearly watch his arm. It just squirts out right there. A Unfortunately, no replay in high school football, so the call on the field stands.
Just replay here in the press box.
Yes.
So it'll be second down and about eight for this Daniel Boone offense, which has dominated the game so far. It is a rivalry game. Anything can happen. That's Worley handing off. That looked like Devon White.
Now for Daniel Boone, you got to take advantage of this. So far here, you want to be able to take advantage of that turnover. Again, so far two turnovers for David Crockett Trailblazers. Perfectly, this clock is already under 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Daniel Boone, got to take advantage of these turnovers.
So Worley's still in the backfield. To his left is Blair. Two men beside him tonight. Here comes Blair in motion. Now Blair sets next to him. It's just going to be a old quarterback sweep. And Worley's going to be close to that first down. He just tries to stretch the ball over. That's going to be really close.
It looks like he's just a little bit short.
So we've already gone for it once on fourth down. It appears they'll do it again as they've crossed the 50, so why not?
And look for Brennan Blair to be lined up in the Wildcat again here on fourth down.
That appears to be what we have. A little different formation here for Boone.
We got a timeout by Daniel Boone.
So we do have a timeout. It's time for us to take one as well. You're watching Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
Is sponsored by Champion Chevrolet Cadillac in Johnson City.
And welcome back to the Muskie Bowl for a key fourth down. Daniel Boone has dominated this game so far, and they're looking to continue that domination. They're about a yard away, Casey.
They're going to go for it, fourth and one. Brennan Blair lined up in the Wildcat. They scored a touchdown in this formation on their last possession. See if they can get a yard here, fourth and one.
So Blair's going to run to the right side, and he's got a hole. He cuts back left. Blair up the middle, and Blair will score, and Daniel Boone is up two touchdowns.
32-yard touchdown run. Obviously, Jeremy Jenkins saw something that he would like this formation. They've gone to the Wildcat early and often. Brennan Blair, two early touchdowns for Daniel Boone as they take a 13-0 lead.
Well, no one expected this, but that's why we love high school football. It is the land of the unexpected, and we are playing at Daniel Boone High School tonight. Jacob Jenkins into the game. Mr. Jenkins will try to make it 14-0. And there's the kick, and it is right down Main Street. 14-0, Boone over Crockett. So, Casey, so far, it's the domination of the ground game.
Yeah, you see, here's the replay. Blair cuts back left, and there is nobody there in the middle of the field, untouched, 32 yards for the touchdown. And this...
Was he pointing at you?
I think he was pointing... maybe he was pointing to our cameraman up there in the end zone. Saying, did you get that right there?
Yeah, we got it. We got it. Yes, sir. Great job by Mr. Blair. He has been the difference in the ballgame so far. Two touchdowns, both on the Wildcat.
I'm sure that's something that maybe David Crockett, not sure if they were expecting that or not, but certainly they're going to have to make that adjustment now. They've seen it a couple times already with Blair out of the Wildcat. Early on, the weather being a factor in this game so far, saw with the muff punt and also the ball slipping out of Larkins' hand, whether, you know, it was called a fumble on the field.
That's really the only call that counts because they're the ones making it.
That last scoring drive for Daniel Boone, four plays, 41 yards. Again, Brennan Blair, 34 of those yards. He's having himself a heck of a first quarter so far.
Good shot of Jenkins. See a little pooch kick again. Oh, and a vicious hit there. The ball's loose, and Boone has it again.
I think the referee's saying he's down.
Man, that ball certainly came out. That was a whale of a hit. We'll have to look at the replay here, Casey, to get it. Who was that truck?
That's Preston Miller. And I think that one was a good call. He was down when that ball came out.
Wow. Some great special teams. Great work by our camera crew there to get that fumble. So here we go. Cade Larkins back in the ballgame from the shotgun. This is handoff here to the running back.
It's Ronkeel Joyner. Olivia, what do you got for us?
Yeah, this rain is making all the difference down here. The coaches here on the sidelines reminding these student athletes just to make sure to keep their heads on straight. Obviously, this is an unexpected score at this point, 14-0, Daniel Boone, but they are just reminding these students, just make sure that you're keeping your hands on the ball at all points tonight.
All right, Olivia, thank you so much. Cade Larkins on a second down and about nine. He's going to put it up, and it's going to be almost intercepted. Some great defense there by Hagan Edwards, who stepped right in front of that one.
Well, that was very lucky there not to be intercepted. See, look, this is the kickoff right here. A big hit by Preston Miller for Daniel Boone. That's really something for in the future. You want to do a fair catch on that because they can't hit you. You call for a fair catch.
That was one of the best hits we've seen all season long. Glad both players were okay. So it'll be third down and long for Cade Larkins. So far, this high-powered offense of David Crockett High School has been stymied. Larkins straight back. It'll be a little screenplay to Hackler. He's got running room. He's got the first down, and that'll be another Champion Chevrolet first down.
Yeah, you can see that play developing there, the wide receiver screen to Hackler. For a Champion Chevrolet first down, that's a big play for David Crockett. They needed that. Already down 14-0. Good job by Larkins lofting that over the line there, then letting your playmakers do the rest as Hackler picks up a first down. Takes a big lick on that play as well at the end there from Daniel Lusk.
This could very well be the final play of the first quarter. 14-0. This is Joyner. He's hitting the backfield, breaks a tackle, but he doesn't break the second one. Daniel Lusk came up and made a pop on him.
And I think that will be the final play of the first quarter. And what a first quarter it is for Daniel Boone. Already up 14-0, PJ.
You're not kidding. 14-0 in the Musket Bowl. You're watching Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
Need special cancer treatments.
So we have a special relationship with St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. In fact, we're the only hospital in the region to have St. Jude standing behind cancer patients. We're Nicewanger Children's Hospital.
It's Truck Month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 19 Crew Cab All-Star, $11,000 off. 19 Extended Cab All-Star, $12,000 off. 19 Light Duty Extended Cab, $12,000 off. 19 2500 Duramax Diesel, $13,771 off. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
At ECU, we've got a mortgage product that fits your needs.
As first-time homebuyers, there are so many different options. It was really kind of intimidating.
But ECU made it easy. They helped us through every step. Whether you're buying your first home or your forever home, come see us at ECU. We know you have questions. We're here to answer them.
I would highly recommend Eastman Credit Union for all your mortgage needs.
Just do it. Don't even think twice about it.
We love ECU.
And we think you will, too.
I think our dogs would highly recommend ECU.
More athletic, more refined, more sport, more utility, more performance, more traction, more confidence. Toyota has taken RAV4, the best-selling SUV in America, and redefined what an SUV can be. Introducing the completely redesigned Toyota RAV4. Now get 1.9 financing for 60 months on a new RAV4, or a low-mileage lease on this RAV4 LE for just $199 a month.
Toyota. Let's go places.
As the lazy days of summer give way to the cool, crisp breezes of autumn, the time comes for a vibrant array of colors, cozy jackets, and great saving at Food City.
This week's save on Food City ground chuck. $2.99 per pound, 3 pounds or more. Strawberries, buy one, get one free. Deli chicken salad or chicken tenders, $5.99 per pound and more. Only at Food City.
It's Truck Month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 20 Colorado, $29.95. 20 Silverado two-wheel drive crew cab, $39.95. 20 Silverado 4x4 extended cab, $31.95. 20 Silverado 4x4 crew cab, $33.95. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
It takes special skills to treat kids.
So we have child life specialists to relate to kids at every age. Even teenagers. We're Nisewanger Children's Hospital.
And welcome back to the Musket Bowl, where they come dressed for the occasion. One of the oldest rivalries in the region and one of the most fierce. And right now, David Crockett trying to get back in this ballgame, down 14-0 as we begin the second quarter. Larkin's up the middle. He'll keep it, but he won't get much, maybe three or four. Hit hard there by the defensive backs that come up for the Daniel Boone Trailblazers.
Got some first quarter stats for you, PJ. Total yards, Daniel Boone 81. David Crockett just 24 yards of offense. They had 21 yards passing, 3 yards rushing. Brennan Blair for Daniel Boone, 6 carries, 58 yards, 2 touchdowns, averaging just under 10 yards a carry in that first quarter. And time of possession, Boone had the ball for 8 minutes, 27 seconds.
Larkins, 3 receivers, 2 out to the right, and then 2 more split out, actually 4 receivers, 2 more split out to the left from the shotgun. Straight back is Larkins. He'll throw it down the field. He's got Hackler out there. He's going to catch it in stride. He'll be brought down just short of the goal line. What a throw and catch.
Yeah, Dante Hackler goes down inside the 5-yard line on that one. That'd be about a 47-yard pass connection there from Larkins to Hackler.
That ball could not have been thrown more perfectly.
Look at the replay here. Nice throw, and Hackler gets behind his man and gets brought down inside the 5.
Look at this. It's got to be our Travis on that one. Right into the hands of the receiver. So that puts David Crockett in business now. They're in the Toyota red zone. Straight handoff for Crockett.
That was Brendan Reed there getting the carry as the Pioneers now for the first time are inside the Toyota red zone. It'll be second and goal now from about the 2-yard line, looks like. Ronkeel Joyner's checked back into the game, number 1 for David Crockett.
That's the thing about this offense for Crockett. Quick strike. They get right back in the game on one play. Larkin's going to put it in the air, and no one's there.
Yeah, he was looking for Prince Colley. I think number 21, maybe a little miscommunication there between Larkins and Colley.
It looked like Larkins was throwing to a spot, and the receiver just didn't make it.
So third and goal from the 2. We'll see what the Pioneers go with here. When they're running those 4 receiver sets, it kind of spreads everybody out. I think maybe you want to get Joyner a carry if you go spread everybody out there and try and win hat for hat in the box.
Larkin has passed for over 10,000 yards in his career. Prolific passer. Now he's just trying to get 2. And he'll hand it off and now keep it. Good fake there. And Larkins gets in for the touchdown. So good belly fake by Larkins. It appeared that Joyner had it for a second. Then he pulled it back and took it in for the touchdown.
That's a good thing Larkins kept that ball, because Joyner, watch on this replay, Joyner was hit behind the line of scrimmage here. If he would have kept the ball, it would have been a big loss. And Larkins makes the right read and gets across for the touchdown. Of course, Cade Larkins, 6'3", and use that big frame to stretch across the end zone for the David Crockett touchdown.
Now Crockett will try to tack on the extra point. And that kick is up, and it's right down the middle. We've got a 14-7 ball game. Wow, and we've got a good one. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
Welcome to Express Checkout. On FriendshipCars.com, you can view inventory from all our locations. Get the best pricing and choose your payment without the hassle. Get an instant cash offer for your trade-in. Research and select a protection package that works best for you. Take advantage of all Express Checkout has to offer and be in and out in under 30 minutes. That's it. It's that easy. Instant pricing and Express Checkout from FriendshipCars.com. Start your new car shopping experience today.
Back here in the Musket Bowl where the band plays on, we've got a 14-7 game. Daniel Boone in the lead. Crockett, though, with that quick strike offense, is back in the ball game. A long pass play setting up a short touchdown run by Cade Larkins. Casey?
Yeah, that play, that scoring drive, PJ, five plays, 55 yards, a minute 57 off the clock. Talk about quick strike there. Then he finds, caps off with a two-yard Cade Larkins touchdown run.
So Googe will once again kick it away. Still a little bit of a drizzle out there. It'll be a short kick. And there's an open spot for it. And Boone is going to pick it up and run it back. It'll be a decent return just over the 35-yard line.
Yeah, it's really good starting field position for Daniel Boone out past the 35. Yard line. Now let's see, really interesting to see here if Daniel Boone continues to go with Blair in the Wildcat there, and how does David Crockett try and stop that, because they have not been able to do it so far.
All these schools have that new iPod series, and that gives you a good idea of how hard it's raining here as you see the lights here at Daniel Boone High School. Here comes Brennan. Brennan Blair over the right side. He'll get a couple.
Jackson Jenkins taking that snap at quarterback. Daniel Boone will play two quarterbacks, not counting Blair and the Wildcats. So it's like three people have taken the snap so far for Daniel Boone, and we're early in the second quarter.
So Boone truly has the three-headed monster. That's what you're telling me. Got to be on your toes with this Daniel Boone offense. A lot of interchangeable parts since the injury to Charlie Cole, the star running back that happened earlier in the year against Greenville. Jackson Jenkins will operate. He'll hand it off. Again, that's White getting some good yardage there, Casey. Close to a first down.
Yeah, it looks like I think he got a first down. Devon White, again, he missed the first couple games of the season. Makes his name as a linebacker. Also can run the ball. He's the power back for Daniel Boone. Nice cut here. Break a couple tackles and picks up a first down for Daniel Boone.
So a Toyota first down there. And Boone is on the move. Jenkins looked like he wanted to hand it off. Maybe somebody ran the wrong way.
Yeah, maybe a little miscommunication on that play right there. So David Crockett, they needed that. You want it, the way Daniel Boone has been running the ball, you want them to play behind the sticks, because if it's, you know, third and three, third and four, they have just too many options to get those yards. And Daniel Boone really running the ball well here tonight so far.
Did you see how Collie was creeping up there from his defensive position, getting closer to the line of scrimmage? If Boone ever wanted to try to throw it deep, there's an opportunity as these safeties are really coming up for Crockett. Another handoff up the middle to Blair. And he got a couple.
That was Collie with the tackle. For David Crockett. Prince Collie, a 6'3 junior, and he is the one getting a lot of interest at the Division I level, just a junior. And that sets up a 3rd and 7 for Daniel Boone.
So Blair and White in the backfield along with Jenkins. Jenkins will throw it. He's a lefty. Throws it out there complete for the first down as he threw a bullet out there to his receiver for his first down.
Phillip Page with the catch. And take a look at this replay. That's just way too much of a cushion here on the outside. I mean, there's not a defender within 5 yards of him when he makes that catch.
Good route by Page as he turned. He was wide open. And Jenkins nailed it. Trailblazers on the move. First down. This will be White. Big hole on the right side. He'll pick up about eight. Devon White is a power back. Runs low to the ground.
Yeah, Devon White, he is a junior, 5'10", 215 pounds. They're not going to give him those extra yards that he crawled there once he got down there, so they're called second and five.
Jenkins with the handoff. Again, it's that man, Brennan. Brennan Blair with a nice game.
We got a flag coming in late here. I think we're going to have a legal block in the back against Daniel Boone. And that's what is a legal block in the back. That was really at the end of the run there against Daniel Boone. That's going to make it, instead of third and short, should be second and long now. Take a look here at the replay. Watch number five right there. You see at the screen right there, Daniel Matherly.
And don't forget about our halftime show, friendshipcars.com halftime report. Case, you'll have scores. We'll review the first half highlights and a lot more stuff coming up on the friendshipcars.com halftime report. Right now it's second down and long for these Trailblazers. Jenkins at quarterback. Be a hander off on a little end around there. And that's Joe Jones coming in from his little wing position.
Well, misdirection here by Daniel Boone, trying to get the defenders to hesitate for just a second there, but David Crockett does a good job snuffing that play out, setting up a third and long. And now if you're the David Crockett defenders, we saw the last third down, they were playing way too soft in coverage there. You got to know where the first down marker is right there.
Jackson's shown he's got a pretty good, Jenkins has shown that he's got a pretty good arm. Jackson Jenkins, that is, a lefty. Third and long, he's going to roll out to the left. He'll throw it up, and that's going to be incomplete. So it's going to be fourth down for Daniel Boone.
This will be a punting situation here on fourth and about 13. Now, if I'm David Crockett here, I almost want to let this ball drop. Don't even attempt to try and catch it here.
Hackler's back there deep. It was Hackler that fumbled that first punt. Morehouse in to boot it away. Hey, what you want to do is just kick it high here. Get it up in those lights and that rain. Makes it difficult to catch. And he does kick it high. Nice.
Hackler's
not
going to try and catch it.
He's going to let this one bounce out of bounds around a 10-yard line where it'll be first down for David Crockett. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, brought to you by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers. What a throw!
When the sun comes up, it's go time, whether at work or at play, on the field or off. Life doesn't stop, and neither should you. So when you get injured, Holston Medical Group is here to get you back on your feet. Our orthopedic and sports medicine physicians deliver quality care that exceeds expectations, specializing in non-surgical techniques and minimally invasive procedures to get you back in the game fast. Now with convenient walk-in access in Bristol at Sapling Grove, we are HMG, your doctor, your family, your health partner for life.
Tonight's School Spotlight is brought to you by your local Toyota dealer.
From the first time you meet Terry Adcock, you can just feel the love and compassion he has for people. He's always smiling and laughing. Adcock has been an important part of Daniel Boone Athletics. He's been the football program's PA announcer for nearly a dozen years.
It's all about the kids. It's not about me. It's anything I can do.
He's also been behind the microphone for almost every other sport at the school.
It just feels good to be a part of the community. You just feel part of a family when you come here and you be a part of the athletics or anything else going on here as well.
Adcock and his family are a much deeper part of the community. Adcock lost his young son 6 years ago and his brother in 2010. The family created the Phil Foundation, in which they help families dealing with a medical crisis. Nearly 100 families have benefited from their willingness to serve.
The love that people showed us, we try to show that to other people. So, like I said, just the community has loved on me so much, so things like this are so easy for me because it's the whole do unto others, and they've done that to us.
Mr. Adcock in the press box with us tonight, doing a great job as always. Right now, it's David Crockett trying to get back in this ballgame, trying to tie it up deep in their own territory. But that man can change that very quickly. Number 16, Cade Larkins. Larkins back to pass. Throw it over the middle. It's going to be dropped. Man was open for a second. It was Britton out there, and he dropped it.
Yeah, really, with the ball on the 12-yard line, you know, David Crockett's one of those few teams where the ball is really makes a difference to how quick they can move here. But you see, Britton would love to have that one back right there.
It hit him in a bad spot, the hands. Yeah, he'd love to have that one back. This kid has made a lot of great catches this year. I'm sure he'll rebound after that. Second down now, and another 10 yards for Crockett. Looks like it's raining a little harder, Casey.
Fortunately for us, we can ask Olivia about that since we're inside.
Yes. We gave her the poncho for a reason. Larkins. Yeah, there's the rain. See, we were not kidding. Coming down tonight. We were due one. 9 perfect weeks and 1 rainy one. Larkins avoiding the pass, now throwing, and he's got Colley. Colley makes a great catch, breaks a tackle. He's up over the 40. He's going out of the bounds. Let's see where they mark it, about the 42.
Really nice play there by Prince Colley making the catch, and Larkins did a good job extending the play here. Watch Larkins. He doesn't see anything. Steps up in the pocket, then steps out, keeps his eyes downfield. Nice catch there by Colley, then picks up some more yards after the catch.
That was actually a better catch than I thought on the replay because it was behind him. He had to turn all the way around, catch it, flip around, and get the good gain, which Colley did pull off and made it look easy. First down for Crockett on the move here in the rain at Daniel Boone High School. And just be a little simple pitch here to Colley, who breaks a tackle and breaks another tackle. And now he'll finally go down, a host of Daniel Boone defenders.
I'll tell you what, I think Prince Colley was hit a couple yards behind the line of scrimmage, ended up picking up about 7 yards on that play. Just would not come down. Take a look here at our Toyota replay. Kind of bobbled the ball at first here. Watch where he breaks a couple tackles here. Another 2 right there.
Takes 3 guys to finally get him down. So it'll be second down and about 3 for Crockett. Remember, they started this drive way back. What was it?
Thrown 12-yard line.
12-yard line.
Now they're 2 yards shy of midfield as we're under 5 minutes left here in the first half.
That's Prince Colley. College prospect all the way out to the left. Cade Larkins looking it over. Looks like he may be changing the play.
He's got a delay game against David Crockett.
Didn't change the play quick enough. Of course, the way Crockett likes to sling it around, 5 yards is not really a big deal to them, but it's something you don't want to see because it just kind of disrupts your offense.
Yeah, you wouldn't expect to see that very often from your senior quarterback. You know, it's so much experience playing in high school football. But again, you know, he tried to check the play there at the end and just took his eye off. You know, there is a play clock in each end zone here at Daniel Boone.
And don't forget, later tonight, we'll be producing the Toyota drive of the game. It'll be in the fourth quarter of this ball game, I should say. That pass by Larkins over the middle, incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed a little high. Now, you mentioned that 5-yard penalty. Now, instead of 3rd and 3, 3rd and 4, it's 3rd and 9. So here's an obvious passing situation in a pretty good rain right now for David Crockett.
Again, welcoming all our viewers on Facebook Live tonight, watching, I'm sure some here in the stadium watching on Facebook Live. We've seen that a lot this year. Welcome aboard, and thanks to Champion Chevrolet, as always, for sponsoring it. Larkins on a big third down, big rush, steps away. He's going to fling it out there. and that's going to be over his receiver. Incomplete.
And you saw Larkins, he kind of bobbled that ball a little bit on the snap. And then had a high throw there on the run. Take a look here on the replay. Watch him. He kind of bobbles the ball for a second, just throws the timing off, and then he has to scramble to his left and tries to throw back to his right and a little bit high as it sails. See the Crockett coaching staff a little upset there, but I think that was an uncatchable ball.
And it looks like Crockett will go for it on fourth down and long.
I think Larkins might back up and could punt this here potentially.
It is going to be a little quick kick. And no one's back for Daniel Boone, but it takes a Boone bounce. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
When you're driving a legend, nothing gets in your way, work or play. The tough built in the USA Tundra, the rugged Tacoma, and the ready for adventure 4Runner. For over 50 years, Toyota has built the best trucks money can buy. Trucks that legends are made of. Now, during Toyota Truck Month, get $1,000 cash back on a new 4Runner, $3,000 back on Tundra, with Toyota Care 2-year no-cost maintenance plan. Drive a legend. Toyota, let's go places. Tonight's Facebook Live game coverage is sponsored by Champion Chevrolet Cadillac in Johnson City.
It's the Musket Bowl tonight, live from Daniel Boone High School. 14-7, Daniel Boone controlling this ballgame on the ground. There's been one big strike by David Crockett, but it's been this story over and over tonight. Boone getting 2 and 3 yards on first down.
And that's Brennan Blair with the carry, and he has been the star for Daniel Boone so far. Both of the Trailblazers touchdowns belong to number one Brennan Blair, the 5'8 junior.
B squared.
Caleb Worley is back at quarterback on this drive for Daniel Boone. Worley is a sophomore.
Worley had a good first quarter. It'll be Worley running to his right this time, and he's just gonna maybe get a yard.
As Ronquil Joyner on the tackle for David Crockett, setting up a third and medium.
Third and how you like your steak? Medium, huh?
Medium well.
I don't think there's a third and medium well, so we'll have to go with third and medium. Extra sauce on this one.
You see Worley trying to wipe his hands off there on that towel between plays here. The rain continues to come down. If you're wondering why you haven't seen our Sky 5 drone yet, that's why it can't be flying in the rain.
So a little jet sweep here by Boone, but the ball is loose. And Boone picks it up and advances it.
And guess who? Brennan Blair recovers the fumble. That's a Toyota first down, and Brennan Blair can do no wrong tonight when Daniel Boone fumbles the ball here. Take a look at the fumble by Jones.
Jones is hit pretty hard from behind. Ball pops out, but right to Brennan Blair.
Blair picks up about another 10 yards on that fumble recovery.
That's called the ground option, I believe. So again, Worley waiting for the snap. He's going to fake the handoff and put it up in the air. You knew this was bound to happen sooner or later, and it was completed out there. Cole Bishop with a nice grab in the ring tonight, and the way those safeties have been coming up, that's been open tonight. First time that Boone's elected to throw it.
Yeah, play action here. Get the linebackers to come up and just throws a perfect throw over Britton's head, and Cole Bishop with the catch, a big first down for Daniel Boone. They are in business at the David Crockett 24-yard line with 2.5 minutes left in the first half.
This game is so much fun because the kids, of course, know each other. They live close to each other. And in social media, well, it's a whole different world. That ball's fumble. Loose again. But Crockett says they have it.
And they do. Dante Hackler makes up for that fumble we had in the first quarter by coming up with one here. First mistake by Daniel Boone tonight.
The first mistake that's hurt them. They've actually profited on a couple mistakes, but you can't keep fumbling the ball. And this one pops loose.
This was Worley on the run here. There's a hit. That was Hackler, Caleb Hackler with the hit that causes the fumble. Then Dante Hackler recovers the fumble for David Crockett. So nice play there by Caleb Hackler.
So it was a double Hackler.
6'3 senior.
Here's Larkins in the rain, straight drop back. Little floater out there, big hit! Oh my goodness! Oh, what a hit by the Boone defense.
That was Daniel Lusk.
Was that Reed that got pulverized? It is Reed.
That's Reed. They're going with the screen. As a Hagan Edwards and Daniel Lusk combined for that big hit for Daniel Boone.
Wow. Two of the hardest hits we've seen all season taking place tonight here in the Musket Bowl. Larkins. He sounded. Sound like I heard a whistle, but maybe that was in the stands.
So Crockett using that screen game here. It went with the running back screen on first down, the wide receiver screen on second down.
And don't forget at halftime, friendshipcars.com halftime report. Casey will review tonight's highlights of the first half, and he'll pass along some scores of some other games.
It's 3rd and 7 here. The clock is a minute and 15 and counting, so it's a big play for David Crockett. They get a first down. They pretty much will have the ball the rest of the half.
Larkins looking deep, throwing hard. High throw for a first down, it looked like.
Yeah, what a catch there by Hackler. He uses all 6'3" of his frame. And now David Crockett, they're going to have to go hurry up. They're going to call a timeout here, actually.
That was a good example of a college throw. He threw that where only Hackler could catch it, Casey. High, but it was a hard catch, but a makeable catch.
Yeah, I mean, when you got, you know, 6'3" out on the outside right there, throw it up, let him make a play. It's David Crockett. They call their first timeout of the first half with exactly 1 minute left.
Let's check in with Olivia Bailey, who's still in the rain. Olivia?
Yeah, I don't know what I did to make Dave Dirks mad, but it is still coming down here. It started about 5 o'clock today, and we're really starting to see these field conditions deteriorate at this point. We've seen several of those fumbles, the ball just slipping through people's hands, but we're also seeing several of the receivers falling down. So it is definitely slick here, and we're starting to see that take effect here in this game.
Good shot of the rain there. That gives you an idea of how hard it is raining here. Parts of the field, most of the field is really good shape, though, considering this is at the latter part of the season, Casey.
Yeah, this is senior night for Daniel Boone, their last home game. They're hoping it's not their last home game. If they can win, whoever wins this game tonight will very likely get a home playoff game. Now, it's not for sure. Tennessee High and Cherokee are playing tonight as well. That outcome will have a big factor in this Region 1 5A.
Really nice tradition that Boone has of honoring all their seniors. They were all here tonight, and it looked like an army of folks with parents, and really nice tribute by Daniel Boone High School. So here we go back to live actions. Larkin's going deep, and he's got a man out there, and it looks complete down the left sideline.
That's Colley. And they faked a wide receiver screen, and then Colley went streaking down the field while he came in motion. They faked a wide receiver screen. Take a look here. Watch 21. He went in motion, faked the wide receiver screen, throw it deep to a streaking Colley. What a throw. What a catch. That's a first down for David Crockett.
So forget about the rain. Those guys say, we're going deep anyway. Colley looks like he's breathing a little hard there. Here comes Larkin. Close to the red zone. Larkin backing up, throwing deep. He's got a man out there, and it's going to be intercepted by Boone.
That's Preston Miller on the interception for Daniel Boone. Miller comes over from the safety position. What a play by Preston Miller.
Let's look at this replay here, Casey, which you can see the safety just comes over and plays the ball.
Yeah, I mean, Hackler got behind the DB, but that ball hung up in the air a long time, allowing Miller to come underneath and make the interception.
That's how you want your defensive backs to play it. And Daniel Boone will try to run out the clock here and go into halftime with a 14-7 lead.
We got a couple flags here. Got false start against Daniel Boone. You don't see that very often when you're trying to take a knee.
Everybody took a knee, unfortunately. 33 seconds to go here in the first half. And Boone just happy to get out of here with that 14-7 lead. Just when it looked like Crockett was knocking on the door to tie it up, big play by their defense.
If both teams with turnovers while driving for potential scores, and Daniel Boone's going to take a knee, and they'll be happy to head to the locker room with a 14-7 lead.
Well, it's a surprising outcome here at halftime, 14-7 Daniel Boone, but that's why they play the Musket Bowl, and that's why we come out here to cover it. 14-7 right now, Daniel Boone in head, ahead, I should say, of David Crockett. We're waiting for Olivia Bailey to corral the coach, and it looks like she's getting close.
Yeah, Coach Jenkins will make his way over there. Remember, David Crockett, they deferred their option at the beginning of the game, so they will receive the second half kickoff.
Well, I'm sure Olivia will be touching on the ground game of this Daniel Boone team and how successful it's been when she gets Coach Jenkins.
Getting a drink here. Probably a lot of yelling here, so we'll send it down to Olivia now with Coach Jeremy Jenkins.
Yeah, Coach, this is a huge rivalry game here. You guys have been able to move the ball on the ground. Just talk a little bit about the success that you've had so far.
Well, that's the key for us. You know, we got to try to keep them off the field as much as we can. Our best offense is to keep them off the field. I mean, that's our best defense, and to eat up the clock and not give Cade as many opportunities, because you see what he can do out there. Our kids are playing hard, line of scrimmage. Right now, we're winning the line of scrimmage, and we're the most physical team, and that's what we wanted to be.
Yeah, and Coach, they just have so many weapons on this David Crockett team. What are you telling your team going into the locker room just to keep them motivated? They're going in up right now.
Well, we just got to do a good job of keeping them in front of us and not let them get any home run plays on us. You know, right there at the end, you can't keep giving them opportunities. We had an opportunity to go up by two scores and turn the ball over. We said that was the key. No turnovers and keep them off the field as much as we can. We got to get that fixed and we'll be all right.
Great. Good luck, Coach. Thank you. Good luck. And that was Coach Jenkins from Daniel Boone High School. They go in with the lead. Casey, PJ, back to you.
All right. Thank you very much, Olivia. If anybody knows this rivalry, Casey, it's Jamie Jenkins. He played in it. He's coached in it. He's seen it one way and another. Oh, man, we've got a great second half to come, and we'll have more halftime for you. We're watching the Toyota Rivals, Friday Night Rivals here, brought to you by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
Join us at East Coast Wings & Grill for craft wings, beer, burgers, skillets, flatbreads, and more. We use the best ingredients to create signature dishes like our award-winning wings made your way. Eat, unwind, and celebrate good times at your local East Coast Wings & Grill.
When the sun comes up, it's go time, whether at work or at play, on the field or off. Life doesn't stop, and neither should you. So when you get injured, Holston Medical Group is here to get you back on your feet. Our orthopedic and sports medicine physicians deliver quality care that exceeds expectations, specializing in non-surgical techniques and minimally invasive procedures to get you back in the game fast. Now with convenient walk-in access in Bristol at Sapling Grove, we are HMG, your doctor, your family, your health partner for life.
It's truck month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 20 Colorado, $29.95. 20 Silverado two-wheel drive crew cab, $39.95. 20 Silverado 4x4 extended cab, $31.95. 20 Silverado 4x4 crew cab, $33.95. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
The Niners look to stake their claim in the West as San Francisco takes on star rookie Kyler Murray in Arizona. Touchdown! Thursday Night Football on Fox.
Thursday night at 7:30 on Fox 39.
Hear that? That's the sound of scrambling eggs, sizzling bacon, and fresh biscuits headed for the breakfast bar. Shoney's. Let's eat.
All trophies and plaques for WCYB's Friday Night Rivals are provided by Eddie's Trophies and Gift Shop in Bristol. Eddie's Trophies also offers medals, plaques, acrylics, glass, and crystal pieces for your business, school, or sports team. That's Eddie's Trophy and Gift Shop online at eddiestrophies.com.
Join us at East Coast Wings & Grill for craft wings, beer, burgers, skillets, flatbreads, and more. We use the best ingredients to create signature dishes like our award-winning wings made your way. Eat, unwind, and celebrate good times at your local East Coast Wings & Grill.
Welcome to FriendshipCars.com's Halftime Report. FriendshipCars.com reminds you to think pink all through October during Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Casey, what's the old song, Rainy Night in Georgia? That rain has moved to Tennessee, obviously.
Yeah, it's raining here in Gray, Tennessee tonight. We're halftime. Daniel Boone leading David Crockett 14-7 in the Musket Bowl. Turnovers has been the story of this game. Both teams with some turnovers. Each team actually turned it over in their last possession of the first half there.
And the ground game of Daniel Boone has really dominated.
Yeah, Brendan Blair, two touchdowns. We'll see. David Crockett will receive the second half kickoff. Before the second half kickoff, we have our FriendshipCars.com halftime report. Now it's time for our Scholar Athlete segment of the week.
Boston Medical Group is proud to recognize our Scholar Athletes, celebrating excellence in athletics and academics.
Cade Larkins could be the all-time leading passer in Tennessee by season's end, but the Mr. Football finalist doesn't let the accolades define him.
Football's not always going to be there, and I know that, you know. It's just a realistic thought, and so after that, you're going to have to get a job in the real world.
Larkins is putting up ridiculous numbers in the classroom, like he does passing yards. He has a 4.11 GPA. He's an officer in the Beta Club, a National Honor Society member, and a student representative on the school board.
He's the ultimate example. We've got a couple guys that, you know, potentially have, you know, the opportunity to play at the next level. But their grades are in question. And, you know, he's a great example to, you know, to help those kids along and, you know, to prove what it means to be, you know, a student athlete and not just an athlete that goes to class.
The one thing I like about him is that he doesn't panic. He thinks about things, and that shows through not only in the classroom, but it also shows through on the football field.
The work goes beyond school. He volunteers at the local food pantry and his church.
Having people like that, you know, have your back, like, you should have the community's back as well. It's a trade-off, and it's the right thing to do.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lindsay Ramey. I'm an orthopedic surgeon with Halston Medical Group, and on behalf of HMG, it is my honor to be here celebrating these two amazing scholar athletes this week. First of all, I'd like to honor Cade Larkins. He's already received his plaque, but he has done an outstanding job this year and was also honored during week two of this award ceremony. And then new this week, I'd like to honor Cade Elliott.
Thank you.
And present you with this plaque.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations to both of these young men.
There's nothing like the feeling of getting a chance to play for your state's university.
I'm committed to play at UT. I'll be signing next month. And I'm super excited about that because they got a good team, good program.
But Daniel Boone senior Cade Elliott is more than just a standout baseball player. In addition to committing to Tennessee and being All-State and the Big 7 Player of the Year last year, Elliott is also a 4.0 student, scored over 30 on his ACT, is a member of the National Honor Society, and volunteers with his church and the Challenger League.
If I get a B, I'm pretty upset about it, but I mean, I push myself as hard as I can. I take classroom above sports usually, and I get my work done.
It's his drive and passion on and off the field that pushes him to excel at both.
School's going to get me farther than baseball will, mainly. I want my education.
All of HMG's scholar athletes have the opportunity to compete for a $5,000 scholarship to be awarded at the end of the season.
Community College Educator Spotlight, Ms. Peggy Wright, the principal of David Crockett High School, and this team has traveled well, all with their umbrellas and ponchos here, and thank you so much for being here with us tonight.
I'm glad to be here. Glad to be here.
And this is our second time talking to you. We're able to promote everything that David Crockett is doing, and there's some big numbers there at the high school. Yeah. First, let's talk about the graduation rates and what you see there at David Crockett.
Okay. Well, Crockett has the highest graduation rate that we've ever had in the history of our school. We're very proud of that. I think the state rate is hovering around 89%, and we're at 92.5, and then our ACT scores are the highest in the school's history as well. And we're very proud of that because ACT scores mean money for college, and so we're encouraging our students to take that test over and over, get that score up, and they are doing that, and we're so proud of them.
And especially in this region, that's, you know, so many students are using that money to go to college and on to do technical education, and we talked a little bit about that before, and that's an important part of David Crockett's curriculum there as well.
Yes, CTE is huge, and I'm very thankful that our state government is really encouraging students to go into career tech education because there's a lot of skilled labor that's needed in our area and in our state, and there's not students to do it. So now they're pushing students to go in that direction, which is great because they never have jobs when they get out of high school.
And I think I have to ask both principals here. This is obviously a rivalry game, the Musket Bowl, and there's just a huge turnout here from both schools. Just talk a little bit about what this means to the students there at David Crockett.
Well, it is a big rivalry, and it's gone on for years and years and years. And, yeah, I know people that don't maybe come to football games normally, they'll come to the Musket Bowl because they just, you know, it's just a great county rivalry. And it's and even though the weather's not that great tonight, it's still a great game. And I can only say the score right now, we're down a little bit, but hey, go Pioneers.
Thank you so much, Miss Wright. That is Miss Peggy Wright from David Crockett High School, the principal there. This has been your Northeast State Community College Educator Spotlight. It's part of your FriendshipCars.com halftime report.
Tonight's Educator Spotlight is presented by Northeast State Community College. We're here to get you there.
Kids are more sensitive to radiation.
So we get x-rays in one take by getting kids to hold perfectly still, which is against their nature. We're Niswonger Children's Hospital.
At first glance, Toyota Highlander XLE makes a powerful statement. With a standard 3.5-liter V6 and the ability to take you anywhere you want to go. Inside, it's all about room and comfort, with spacious seating for 8 and 5 USB charging ports. Plus, Toyota Safety Sense, our most advanced safety features, are standard equipment. Now get $3,000 cash back on a built-in USA Highlander, or get a low-mileage lease for just $249 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
What can you find? Places to unwind, places you can share, and places just to, well, stand and stare. Maybe it's time for you to visit a very special place called Ina.
At ECU, we've got a mortgage product that fits your needs.
As first-time homebuyers, there are so many different options. It was really kind of intimidating.
But ECU made it easy. They helped us through every step. Whether you're buying your first home or your forever home, come see us at ECU. We know you have questions. We're here to answer them.
I would highly recommend Eastman Credit Union for all your mortgage needs.
Just do it. Don't even think twice about it.
We love ECU.
And we think you will, too.
I think our dogs would highly recommend ECU.
We've got the new Lexus to fit your life.
And your style.
Drive a new RX 350 for only $389 a month.
Nothing else feels quite like a Lexus.
And nothing else feels like the buying experience at Lexus of Kingsport, where our commitment to you sets us apart.
Kids' immune systems are still learning to fight.
So illnesses can overpower them more quickly. That's why we provide pediatricians 24/7. Expert fighters, ready to rumble. We're Niswonger Children's Hospital.
You're watching FriendshipCars.com's halftime report. FriendshipCars.com reminds you to think pink all through October during Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Educator Spotlight. We are now here with Daniel Boone's principal. This is Mr. Campbell. Thank you so much for hosting us here for Friday Night Rivals. It's been a fun game so far.
Absolutely. We want to thank WCYB for coming out. This has been a great, you know, atmosphere for the game, great atmosphere for both sides. You know, Washington County is very fortunate that you all spend the time and the effort to come out and make this happen.
Well, thank you so much. And Daniel Boone has a lot to be cheering about tonight here. And also, we saw Senior Night recognize several of the other teams recognized here. Daniel Boone's had a great fall season in many different athletics here.
We absolutely have. Our volleyball team just came back from the state tournament. I was lucky enough to go down there and watch them. We really felt like we were the second or third best team, along with Dobbins Bennett. So our area was very well represented. Then our boys and girls cross country teams just qualified for the state in another week. So you know, we've been very, very lucky. Our football team is competing against a great Crockett team. So, you know, we try to say, you know, a well-rounded student. You know, it's, athletics is, of course, is a piece of it. Our ROTC program is nationally ranked, and we're in the top three every year. For 21 consecutive years, they've been recognized. So, you know, Daniel Boone is just so fortunate to have great people, adults and students, and that's what people don't understand. I've been lucky enough to be here 31 years, and it's because of the people.
And the JROTC, we saw them present the colors earlier. It was a beautiful ceremony there as they sang the national anthem as well. But you did talk about that overall student perspective. perspective here. And that's really what it's all about is the academics. What opportunities are here at Daniel Boone?
Well, you know, we have the college and career ready piece. So, you know, with the college piece, we offer several AP classes, advanced placement classes, our dual enrollment classes that we offer with Northeast State. We offer the most that we can offer without being an adjunct campus. So, you know, the teachers come to our kids here. We're so fortunate, you know, from the AP statistics all the way, you know, psychology, sociology. So our students have great opportunities, and that's, you know, what we try to get them. I do want to brag on our ACT scores. We increased 0.9 of a point as an average last year. Every indicator, math, reading, science, all of that, we are above state average. So, you know, we're lucky with, you know, with the teaching staff and structures we have, but our students excel in a lot of areas as well. Dual credits with ETSU, you know, we're just so fortunate to have the opportunities. Our motto is learning today, leading tomorrow, and that's what we're trying to push our kids to do, just like our adults, you know. So, you know, again, on the college side, then on the CTE side, on the career readiness side, you know, we offer industry certifications where the student can go right out and, you know, get a job, work keys test, the work ethics diploma, where, you know, we're trying to link our students with the business and industry in our area. You know, we have teachers that are, you know, that are certified. I mean, you know, we're just so lucky. I could probably talk to you all night, and I know we're running out of time. But, you know, again, thank you all so much for giving this opportunity.
And thank you so much, Mr. Campbell. And you can see the support here tonight at Daniel Boone High School. That was your Educator Spotlight, sponsored by Northeast State Community College.
Tonight's Educator Spotlight is presented by Northeast State Community College. We're here to get you there.
It's track month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 19 Tracks, $15,995. 19 Equinox, $20,995. 19 Blazer, $26,995. 20 Traverse, $29,995. 20 Tahoe, $42,995. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
Our last slide there about co-signing agreements. I know we haven't actually made a that's lunch.
The Relief by Jersey Mike's. Be a sub above.
Welcome to Express Checkout. On friendshipcars.com, you can view inventory from all our locations. Get the best pricing and choose your payment without the hassle. Get an instant cash offer for your trade-in. Research and select a protection package that works best for you. Take advantage of all Express Checkout has to offer and be in and out in under 30 minutes. That's it. It's that easy. Instant pricing and Express Checkout from friendshipcars.com. Start your new car shopping experience today.
Sunday night. It's a rematch of the first Super Bowl. And it may be a preview of the next. Packers. Chiefs. All eyes on Sunday Night Football.
It's truck month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 19 Crew Cab All-Star, $11,000 off. 19 Extended Cab All-Star, $12,000 off. 19 Light Duty Extended Cab, $12,000 off. 19 2500 Duramax Diesel, $13,771 off. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
And welcome back to Nathan Hill Stadium. It's halftime at the Musket Bowl. We've had an exciting first half. Casey, let's talk about some stuff.
Yeah, let's check out some of these first half highlights. A lot of good plays in the first half, both sides of the ball. Of course, you can't have good plays until both teams run out on the field before the game. As the Musket Bowl was fired up before, the rain is picking up as the game's gone on. Dante Hackler muffs a punt for David Crockett, the first turnover of the game. And then Brennan Blair out of the Wildcat runs it in for a couple yards out with 7-0 Daniel Boone. And then Cade Larkins, this one, here's a big play, was called a fumble. You know, that was not the correct call, but that's what it was called. Should have been an incomplete pass, but Daniel Boone takes advantage of the good fortunes they received. Brennan Blair on 4th and 1. He goes 32 yards untouched for the touchdown. It's 14-0 David Crockett, or Daniel Boone, but David Crockett would come back. Cade Larkins with a pretty throw here right into the breadbasket of Hackler that goes inside the five, and then Larkins keeps it here from 3 yards out, makes it 14-7. Daniel Boone, David Crockett trying to get back in it here and tie the game. Larkins to Prince Cauley down the sidelines, and thought David Crockett in business, but at the end of the first half here, Preston Miller comes up with the interception for Daniel Boone, does a great job out of the safety position, coming over and picking off the pass, and that is how the first half ended. 14-7 here, your first half stats. And PJ, this is what we kind of thought. David Crockett doing their damage in the passing game. Daniel Boone doing theirs in the rushing game. Crockett over 150 passing. Boone over 100 rushing. But the big one, 3 turnovers in the first half for David Crockett.
And as we mentioned earlier, Cade Larkins needs, he needs about 839 yards to break the all-time record. So he's already got 152. He's on pace for a 300-yard game. He would be well on his way, Casey, if he could do that.
He would, you know, because after tonight, they got another game next week against Morristown East, and then likely at least one playoff game as well after that. So both teams are back on the field going through warm-ups as we're getting ready to begin the second half here in a couple minutes. And there's one other score to pass along, which is a big key in this game, is Tennessee High's up 28-7 over Cherokee. We'll have more of our halftime report coming up right after this.
Thanks for watching FriendshipCars.com's halftime report. FriendshipCars.com reminds you to think pink all through October during Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
There's only one way to make a statement. Make it in a new Ford Mustang from Empire Ford in Abingdon. The classic performance car that only gets better inside and out. Take one for a spin and you'll be blown away.
Come see why there's only one. Empire Ford in Abingdon, Virginia.
Trying to please everyone? With the delicious selections on Shoney's buffet and menu, you'll find something for everyone. Family time calls for your favorites. The Slim Jim sandwich, All-American burger, or the soup salad and fruit bar. All fresh for your family at Shoney's.
All trophies and plaques for WCYB's Friday Night Rivals are provided by Eddie's Trophies and Gift Shop in Bristol. Eddie's Trophies also offers medals, plaques, acrylics, glass, and crystal pieces for your business, school, or sports team. That's Eddie's Trophy and Gift Shop, online at eddiestrophies.com.
When you're driving a legend, nothing gets in your way, work or play. The tough built in the USA Tundra, the rugged Tacoma, and the ready for adventure 4Runner. For over 50 years, Toyota has built the best trucks money can buy. Trucks that legends are made of. Now, during Toyota Truck Month, get $1,750 cash back on any new 2019 Tacoma. Or lease a new Tacoma 4x4 double cab for $219 a month. Drive a legend. Toyota, let's go places.
When the sun comes up, it's go time, whether at work or at play, on the field or off. Life doesn't stop, and neither should you. So when you get injured, Holston Medical Group is here to get you back on your feet. Our orthopedic and sports medicine physicians deliver quality care that exceeds expectations, specializing in non-surgical techniques and minimally invasive procedures to get you back in the game fast. Now with convenient walk-in access in Bristol at Sapling Grove, we are HMG, your doctor, your family, your health partner for life.
There's only one way to shop pre-owned. The one and only climate-controlled indoor auto mall at Empire Ford's Used Car Supercenter. Rows of quality late model vehicles at everyday sale prices.
Come see why there's only one. Empire Ford Used Car and Truck Supercenter in Abingdon, Virginia.
And we are here with David Crockett's coach here. And, Coach, this is a rivalry game, very close game here. Talk a little bit about what you told your guys there in the locker room.
Well, you can't turn the ball over 3 times in the first half and expect to be successful. You know, they ran the ball on us with some success there early in the half. Thought we made some adjustments. We just got to take care of the football and be able to run it here in the second half with the weather.
Yeah, and, Coach, the rain really making a difference here. You guys are a passing team. Is that impacting you at all?
It has a little bit, but, you know, we've got to be able to run the football to win games, and hopefully we can do it in the second half.
Great. Coach, good luck. Thank you so much. And you are hearing from David Crockett's head coach. They are a passing team, Casey, PJ. We've talked about that all season long, really making a difference here. So it sounds like we might see them on the ground a little more in the second half.
Olivia, thank you very much. Hayton Chandley didn't look very happy, Casey, and I can't imagine he is very happy with the way his team played.
Yeah, he kind of said, you know, I was saying we showed the stats. There are 3 first-half turnovers, and it was interesting to hear Coach say he got to run the ball more. So let's see Ron Keel Jr. maybe get a concerted effort to get him the ball. Also, Brendan Reed, David Crockett. We'll receive this opening kickoff in the second half. So we'll see if they go to the running game a little more here in the elements.
I guess this is why Crockett deferred in the first half. They wanted to get the first shot here in the second half. And trailing 14-7, it's going to work out pretty good for them as we get ready for the Toyota kickoff here in Gray. Daniel Boone High School. It's the Musket Bowl. Played every year since 1971, one of the oldest rivalries in the region.
You heard Jeremy Jenkins before halftime tell Olivia, want to keep the ball away. Daniel Boone had the ball for 15 minutes, 5 seconds in the first half. David Crockett for 8 minutes, 55 seconds, almost 2-1 time of possession in favor of the Trailblazers.
And so Boone will kick it off. That's Jenkins. Another short kick, a little more air to this one, but that's going to go out of bounds, which is a penalty. Great field position then for David Crockett High School.
I don't think that's what Jeremy Jenkins wanted to see on that second half kickoff right there. They'll put the ball to the 35-yard line.
And we'll see if Crockett changes its offensive philosophy, going more to a run attack. Of course, it's a whole second half to play, 14-7 ball game.
It was really incumbent on the offensive line if they want to improve this running game for David Crockett. They need to open up some holes here and be more physical in the second half.
And Larkins does hand off to Joyner. And Joyner went nowhere. It's one thing to want to run the ball. It's another thing to run the ball. You have to have that offensive line performing, especially here in the rain. Second down and long. 10 yards for Crockett.
Coach Jenkins telling Olivia, you know, that we were the more physical team in the first half, and that was the case, and certainly David Crockett going to try and reverse that, or otherwise it's going to be hard for them to run the ball here in the second half.
The two biggest hits in the first half delivered by Daniel Boone High School. From the shotgun. Larkins, another handoff to Joyner, and now he's going to keep it, and for another no-gain run. That was Larkins. Run that belly play where he puts it in the belly of Joyner and decides whether to let Joyner take it or he takes it. He takes it. Wouldn't have mattered. I think either one would have been tackled.
So far, you know, Coach Chandley being a man of his word, saying they wanted to run the ball. Two plays in the third quarter, two runs, but you gained no yards on those two runs. So now you're going to have to put the ball back in the air with 16. Not a bad option if you're David Crockett.
Sometimes you got to do what you got to do. The thing that Crockett does better than anybody, throw the ball. Larkins guns it for the first down. He has his receiver complete. That will be a first down.
Dante Hackler with the first down. That's who Larkins was looking for in his interception as they pick up a Champion Chevrolet first down there to end the first half. Again, with the passing game, you know, Daniel Boone has to be very weary of that. You would think the Pioneers would be able to win these one-on-one matchups at the line of scrimmage to get some running room for Ronquil Joyner.
Larkins rolling out to the right, evading the rush, taking his time, and he's just going to have to go out of bounds. A little extracurricular activity, but it is in the rain, so no harm, no foul. That was a smart decision by Larkins. Everybody was covered. Just tuck it up, get what you can.
We'll take a look here at the replays. He runs out of bounds, and he kind of gets pushed a little bit into one of the players on the sidelines for Daniel Boone. But, yeah, I like that. No harm there on either side. Actually gave him a gain of 1 on the play, so it'll be 2nd and 9.
So it was a positive offensive play. Larkins, oh, he's going to fumble this one. Now he's recovered and guns it over the middle to his receiver, who's covered by two people. Somehow he made the catch.
That's Prince Colley.
That's Colley with a tough catch. Yeah, another first down, Casey.
Yeah, that's not how you want to draw the play up here, is he drops the snap a little bit low, but Larkins picks it up, resets, and with a laser to Colley for a first down.
If you notice on that replay, the focus of Larkins' eyes, he never took his eye off the receiver, although he was fumbling around with the ball. Good view from behind as Larkins looks like he's going to change the play now. He's asking the coach, what are we doing? Clock running down. Down to 5 seconds. Just got it off. Larkins in the middle, dancing around. Lets it go. and that'll be out of bounds. Colley was double teamed that time. No way to make that catch. Again, for all you folks not watching on television, you're probably watching on Facebook. We welcome you tonight to Facebook Live, coverage provided by Champion Chevrolet of Johnson City. Facebook Live. We've enjoyed having our Facebook Live audience all season long. Got a lot of nice comments from you folks. Keep them coming. Be your last chance to comment. This being our last game of the year on Friday Night Rivals. From the shotgun, second down and long for Crockett. Larkins airs it out. And that ball is incomplete. No flag, although it appeared that Hackler wanted one.
You see here on the replay, this is all a timing throw right here. Larkins throws the ball before Hackler turns around.
Good call. Incomplete pass. Good defense there by Daniel Boone. As you said, that's a complete timing play. Larkins has to trust his receiver's going to be there.
Absolutely. You know, he just maybe threw him a little bit out. So maybe he was expecting to cut outside a little more. But here's third and long. They've had a couple third down conversions on this drive. They need another one here at the 41.
Three wide receivers to the left, and it's Larkins going up the middle in a surprise draw play. He's going to be just short, but well within range.
Yeah, they're definitely going to go for it now. I think you have to pick up about 7 yards there. It looks like it's going to be fourth and three.
So they had three wide receivers to the left, two wide receivers to the right, and Larkins runs a quarterback draw. Pretty good play.
Yeah, that was a quarterback keeper all the way. One of their best running plays of the game so far. Again, fourth and three. You'd expect them to have 16 throw the ball here, Larkins. I mean, their running game has been pretty much non-existent so far tonight.
That slant pass is almost unstoppable.
A 3 and 21 are who you want to key on if you're Daniel Boone.
There's that little slant, but it's incomplete off the hands of Hackler. That was fourth down. So the play was there, just incomplete. Look at the replay.
Ball just squirts right through the hands of Hackley. That would have likely been a first down for the Pioneers, and he's looking at his hands like, how did that happen?
Even with the gloves these kids wear in the rain, it's still a tough chore. So Daniel Boone will take over with their rotating quarterbacks. Looks like Worley's back in there. And he hands to Britton Blair for a short gain. Brennan Blair, number one, and he has been number one tonight in a number of categories, Casey.
Yeah, both of the touchdowns for Daniel Boone tonight so far. Of course, Daniel Boone running for 108 yards in that first half.
He's second down and long. Worley from the shotgun. Fakes the handoff. He'll keep it this time, go off the tackle. Go across the 40-yard line and dive in for a pretty good game.
Yeah, picked about six on the play there. Going to be about maybe third and three, third and four here on third down. Look at the replay. This is a run by Worley. Maybe picked up about an extra yard or two after contact. Again, Worley, 6'2", sophomore.
He's got a nose for the football, too.
Now he's on the sidelines here on third down. It's like Devon White's in the Wildcat. Maybe off, no, he's off to the side. Blair in the Wildcat.
And it's going to be White with the carry, trying to go outside. He's going to be close to that first down. Pins on the marker. Boone says we got it.
And they got it.
Well, this Wildcat play has changed everything for this Daniel Boone offense.
One of the first times Blair's actually handed it off, though, as the Wildcat, get White the ball, and he needed four, and he got about 4.5. It's a big first down, Champion Chevrolet first down for Daniel Boone after David Crockett turned it over on downs.
Daniel Boone. Blair with a huge hole. Oh, and he falls and fumbles, and Crockett has it.
We're going to say he was down.
The refs are saying he was down.
The refs are saying he was down.
It did appear that he may have tripped over his own player when he went down to the ground.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about that. And we can
get a replay here, but that definitely went off. He definitely ran into his own man. We'll see if the ball comes out before. Oh, that's a fumble.
It's a fumble.
That was another missed call by the officials. That was a fumble. Very lucky, Daniel Boone. That's two times they have had the been on the good side of a wrong call tonight.
Worley back in there. He'll try the right side and get two or three.
This is a game where Hayden Chandler was wishing we could challenge plays because he'd be two for two if he could.
The bounce of the ball. Nevertheless, that was a terrific run again by Blair, who just has a way of sniffing out those holes, and he's got a great cutback style about him.
Those plays have been working for Daniel Boone tonight. Blair's got to be approaching about 100 yards now rushing in the game.
Worley hands it to Blair, and there he goes up the middle. He's got one man to beat, and he will. Brennan Blair with a touchdown.
33 yards, and I bet you that one puts him over 100 yards for the game. That's a hat trick for Brennan Blair, his third touchdown of the game. It's now 20-7, Daniel Boone.
Double B turning on the Jets there with a great run up the middle. Again, as we just said, he can kind of sense the holes and make the most of it.
What a game for Blair to have his best game of the season in the Musket Bowl. Three touchdowns already.
Jenkins on for the extra point. He's been perfect so far tonight. And he puts it up and right down the middle again. Daniel Boone leading David Crockett 21-7. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
More athletic, more refined, more sport, more utility, more performance, more traction, more confidence. Toyota has taken RAV4, the best-selling SUV in America, and redefined what an SUV can be. Introducing the completely redesigned Toyota RAV4. Now get 1.9 financing for 60 months on a new RAV4. Or a low-mileage lease on this RAV4 LE for just $199 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
Welcome back to Nathan Hell Stadium on the campus here of Daniel Boone High School. Ken Greenfield, where the Musket Bowl is being played tonight, and so far it's been a surprise, 21-7, and Daniel Boone's ground game has been the difference.
That scoring drive, six plays, 66 yards, just under 3 minutes off the clock. Brennan Blair now has 119 yards rushing and three touchdowns.
Will Blair's run be the Toyota drive of the game? That's still to be determined. That'll be coming up in the fourth quarter, the Toyota drive of the game.
Blair averaging just under 10 yards a carry tonight.
We just checked in with our weather folks. It appears that this rain is here to stay. So if Crockett is to come back, they're going to have to throw it in the rain, Casey. Jenkins will kick it off. Another little pooch kick. A big bounce. And Crockett will return it. That's Colley going up the left side. He's got some daylight. He's got one man to beat. Jenkins, now another. And he's going to be run down from behind. Great return by the Pioneers.
Yeah, Prince Colley right there. Daniel Lusk saves the touchdown for Daniel Boone.
The kicker was out there on an island, Jacob Jenkins, and he just slowed him down enough for folks to run him down.
They made him cut back inside, used the sideline as an extra defender right there.
That has to be the worst feeling in the world when you're a kicker and the fastest guy on the field's coming right at you.
But he went to the sideline, made him cut back in, and then a couple guys take him down there. But David Crockett going to start inside the 35-yard line here at Daniel Boone.
Larkins from the shotgun, going to roll to the right, big rush, little screen, flare out to the left, and he finds his man. As Larkins finds him down the left sidelines.
That's Brendan Reed.
That is Reed, and that's going to be a touchdown. What a play.
I have never seen a screen pass thrown that high in the air before.
It was like a
touchdown.
Punt.
Unbelievable play. You have to have a lot of trust knowing that is going to be wide open. And it was. There was not a defender anywhere near that ball.
And I'm not sure what Chandley's saying here. He came down to argue with the official.
What a response there for David Crockett. Again, I can't wait to see this replay here. Maybe unbelievable how high that ball was thrown for a screen pass.
Reed just floated out there and was wide open. And the boot by Crockett is up, and it's good. It's a 21-14 game.
Take a look. Here it is again as we go to break.
Wide open. And he got one guy to beat, and he does. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
Welcome to Express Checkout. On FrenchofCars.com, you can view inventory from all our locations. Get the best pricing and choose your payment without the hassle. Get an instant cash offer for your trade-in. Research and select a protection package that works best for you. Take advantage of all Express Checkout has to offer and be in and out in under 30 minutes. That's it. It's that easy. Instant pricing and Express Checkout from FrenchofCars.com. Start your new car shopping experience today.
So we've had two unique plays tonight, the ground option and now the arm punt. I can't take credit for that. Our director came up with that, but that's pretty good.
I think what Coach Chandler was talking about is they added 15 seconds back on the game. Well, here's again, look at the play. Watch Reed flip through. Look how it's easy.
Watch how high it is.
Out of your screen almost.
And Reed had to wait on it for like 5 minutes. It's like the defense didn't even realize what was going on. They were kind of like, what's going on? Where'd that ball go?
Just when you think you've seen it all, you see something you never seen before.
No kid.
And it goes as a 32-yard touchdown.
So Crockett will kick it off with another short kick. And Boone fumbles it, but the ball's on the ground. It's a scrimmage for it, a skirmish. But it looks like Boone's going to recover it.
You don't want to be at the bottom of that pile. Right there is now the referee's got to pull some people off. And
these guys are going to have to start calling for fair catches on these short little bloop kicks.
And Daniel Boone does recover.
So they'll have some pretty good field position here. It's about the 35-yard line. Close to 36, I suppose.
So can David Crockett's defense figure out a way to stop this rushing attack of Daniel Boone, primarily Brennan Blair?
They have not been able to do it all night. And again, another big run. That was White, I believe.
I'm sure the defense, you know, they're thinking, Boone is thinking, okay, they're going to be keying on Blair. Let's use him as a decoy and get the ball to Devon White. He picks up 4 yards on first down.
You expect nothing less than a terrific ball game here in the Musket Bowl. And that's what we've got tonight, 21-14. Daniel Boone trying to get back on the scoreboard. Another carry by White. Nowhere to go this time.
Yeah, big Tony Davis in on that play, and that's what David Crockett needs to see, more of that. Big number 58 with a big stop. I believe just the second time we've called his name tonight for David Crockett. Now be a big third down. You see, watch the penetration. Big number 58 gets right here. Beats his man.
Oh, boy.
And you're not going to win many one-on-one battles against Mr. Davis.
Oh, wow. That was a heck of a hit. FriendshipCars.com replay tonight.
It's third and six.
Looks like Jenkins is in at quarterback now. The left-hander rolling, throwing. It's going to be picked off by Crockett. Crockett has the ball on an interception.
That's Dante Hackler. Again, every time he makes a mistake, he makes up for it. He had that drop on fourth and three. Now he comes up with the interception. Dante Hackler responding. That's what you want to see out of your seniors.
You're watching Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
When the sun comes up, it's go time, whether at work or at play, on the field or off. Life doesn't stop, and neither should you. So when you get injured, Holston Medical Group is here to get you back on your feet. Our orthopedic and sports medicine physicians deliver quality care that exceeds expectations, specializing in non-surgical techniques and minimally invasive procedures to get you back in the game fast. Now with convenient walk-in access in Bristol at Sapling Grove, we are HMG, your doctor, your family, your health partner for life.
It's the most enthusiasm we've seen all night long from the Crockett sideline, and I'm not sure if they all shop at the same place, but they have some colorful ponchos.
Student section representing for the visitors tonight here, a couple of brave souls without a shirt.
And that's bravery or stupidity, one of the two in this weather.
It is a rainy night in Gray, Tennessee. Kate Larkins from the shotgun, waiting for the snap. Larkins up the middle. He's got some running room. Breaks a tackle, spins, and inside the 30-yard line. Good run for the quarterback.
Now you like to see them lowering their shoulder, but if I'm the coaching staff, I would get nervous every time I see 16 lower his shoulder like that, because that is the arm that's going to carry the Pioneers the rest of this season here.
Breaks a good tackle. Takes a couple of guys to get him down. So second down and short for David Crockett. Pioneers on the move, looking to tie this ball game. There's a handoff. Joyner. Joyner spins, gets down into the 20-yard line.
That's the best run of the night for Ronkeel Joyner. Take a look at the replay here. Joyner, again, his best run of the night. Now, PJ, as David Crockett gets further inside, as they're getting closer to the end zone here, the field shrinks, and that makes those passing lanes a little smaller. That's why you need to have that running game when you get down in the red zone, because those passing lanes become a little tighter.
Champion Chevrolet first down. Larkins with the snap. Another handoff to Joyner. He waits, hesitates, and then he motors for a couple. Maybe three. And we're in the Toyota red zone.
Looks like Joyner is kind of limping a little bit here as he's asking to come out of the game.
I just noticed Joyner wearing a knee brace on that right knee.
I think Brendan Reed will come in. He's the one who scored the touchdown the last possession on the screen pass for the Pioneers.
The famous arm punt touchdown. Larkins waiting for the snap.
We got a false start against David Crockett.
Their offense has done this a couple of times tonight, Casey. You think it's the rain or just what is it?
Sometimes you're just a little too eager there and ready to go. They've been moving the ball. You know, their linemen wanted to fire off there, and they're just a little eager. So second and 12 now.
Larkins all alone throws it out here to his receiver, who gets it down to the 20. Hit hard by the Daniel Boone defense. That's Colley getting collided with a couple of guys.
Yeah, Joe Jones, one of them in there on the hit. That's going to be a third and 9. Because we're under 90 seconds left here in the third quarter.
Everything's shaping up to be an amazing fourth quarter here in the rain.
Daniel Boone making some defensive substitutions here along the defensive line. Figuring this is could be a passing situation on third and 9. Maybe Larkins wants to run it here. We're going to have a timeout here by Daniel Boone. So that's our first timeout of the second half.
So if you're Jeremy Jenkins, what are you telling your defense?
Well, that formation that David Crockett had, they went 5 wides. Larkins was by himself. I would think, we've seen that formation, and he does the quarterback run right away here on the design quarterback run. So maybe it's be aware if they come out in that formation. Larkins, because it's 3rd and 9, but in these field conditions, I don't think David Crockett's going to attempt a field goal. So you're looking at, you got 2 downs to pick up 9 yards.
And we want to hear from you out there in Facebook land. Send us some comments tonight. Our Facebook Live coverage, sponsored always by Champion Chevrolet.
So I think he's probably making sure someone's keeping an eye on 16, because he has been running the ball a little more here in the second half. And also, I think you've got to almost double team Larkins and Colley. Make somebody else beat you. Make Britton beat you. Make Reed beat you. I mean, he did beat you before. Now, we'll be interested to see if David Crockett comes out in the same formation. Looks like they are. They got 5 wide receivers.
Yep. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. We've seen him run the quarterback draw a couple of times out of this formation.
Hackler is at the bottom of the screen.
Colley's wide left. He looks left. He throws over the middle. He's got his receiver complete. That looks like a first down, Casey.
I think that's Colley.
Kala came all the way down from the left side, did a crossing pattern, and Larkins nailed it.
Yeah, the offensive line did a good job there because there's some pressure from Daniel Boone coming, and Kala makes a great catch, and that's a first down. Now first and goal for the Pioneers. The ball's at the 9-yard line. That's a Champion Chevrolet first down as we're under a minute left here in the third quarter. Play clock now just inside 10 seconds here.
Larkins waiting for the snap. Straight drop back. He's going to throw it to the corner. Britton's out there. He's going to leap, and there's a pass interference flag.
Yeah, that was a pass interference there. And that's a right call right there. Mason Britton, the intended receiver.
It looked like the defender didn't even look back at the ball. That's always going to get a flag when you do that. But he was wide open, so the defender really didn't have a choice.
Got pass interference as the call, and take a look at the replay here. And Larkin's throwing this to the far side of the field, and Brennan Blair, yeah, never turns around. That's a easy call for the officials.
The old face guard.
That's half the distance there to the goal and the penalty there, so the ball's just inside the 5-yard line.
Larkins hands it to Reed. Reed off the left side, and he's in for the touchdown. We're 1 point away from being tied.
How about Brendan Reed, his second touchdown of the game, one passing, now one rushing for the Toyota touchdown, and it's 21-20 now late in the third quarter. Brendan Reed stepping up, the 5'10 sophomore.
Reed getting some high fives on the sideline.
We got a David Crockett player down.
Maybe a cramp. That's the big lineman.
That's Tony Davis. I don't think he ever leaves the field. Tony Davis, the 6'4", 285-pound junior.
And that's on a good day. He's a big guy. We've talked to him after the game before. They're treating him for a cramp. See when they pull up on the toe like that. Kind of an unusual night to get a cramp. It's cool. It's rainy. You wouldn't expect a cramp, but
again,
it happens.
I don't think he leaves the field. I mean, yeah. He plays every play, offensive line, defensive line, even there on the extra point.
One thing we love to do on Friday Night Rivals, give away money, and that's what we're going to do right now.
Toyota and your East Tennessee Toyota dealers are combining resources to support our area high schools. We stand together as community partners for our high school athletes and their families to help schools and get students get the most out of their high school years. Toyota is proud to join WCYB, CW, and Fox 39 to provide each host team with a charitable donation to their school. Proudly presented by Toyota and your East Tennessee Toyota dealers. Toyota is proud to bring you tonight's Friday Night Rivals matchup between two great area high schools.
Thank you, Olivia. Good news to report. Mr. Davis was helped off the field. Looks like he'll be okay. And now David Crockett will try the extra point. Googe on to boot it. Good angle. 1 point away from tying the ball game. Good snap. Kick up. And it appears
no good.
To be no good as he pushed it to the right. So Daniel Boone continues to lead this game as they have all night.
You can never take extra points for granted, especially under less than ideal weather conditions. That one just off to the right. So Daniel Boone remains in the lead, 21-20. Under 30 seconds left here. Let's take a look at the extra point from the backside here. And this one's going to stay just off to the right side. And
missed it by that much. Your FriendshipCars.com replay.
And you figure that one is going to have an impact on the way this game unfolds in the final 12 minutes and 28 seconds here.
expect the unexpected, because that's what happens when you play the Musket Bowl. As far as the kickoffs have gone tonight, usually a short, high kick.
And they have been adventurous. Again, maybe you want to see somebody call for a fair catch. They do those high pooch kicks. That last scoring drive for David Crockett, 6 plays, 41 yards, 3 minutes, 17 seconds off the clock. Officials stopping play right here as we'll reset.
Appears there's be some confusion here on the clock. We have 28 seconds left here in the third.
So Edison Googe, who just missed that potential game-tying extra point, will kick it off for the Pioneers as they trail by a point. 28 seconds left in the third.
Little squib kick. This time Boone falls on it. And it's covered up. And it'll be first down from the 35.
That was Preston Miller. You see, he laid on that ball for several seconds. Want to make sure no confusion on that one there.
Take no chances.
Yes. You have Daniel Boone, which I expect after that interception on the last throw by Jenkins there, I would be going to bet a lot of money that this would be a running play here on first down. Likely would be the last play of the third quarter.
He's betting the house on a run, folks. It will be a run. It's going to be a good run, too, as Blair gets about an 8-yard gain.
And I don't think Coach Jenkins will be in any hurry to get another playoff here, and they're going to let this third quarter clock expire, and we'll be heading to the fourth with a 1-point game.
Well, we certainly will as that clock ticks down. It's Daniel Boone 21, David Crockett 20. We played three, but there's still one quarter to go. And we'll have it for you when Toyota Friday Night Rivals continues, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
It's Truck Month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 20 Colorado, $29.95. 20 Silverado two-wheel drive crew cab, $39.95. 20 Silverado 4x4 extended cab, $31.95. 20 Silverado 4x4 crew cab, $33.95. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
At ECU, we've got a mortgage product that fits your needs.
As first-time homebuyers, there are so many different options. It was really kind of intimidating.
But ECU made it easy. They helped us through every step. Whether you're buying your first home or your forever home, come see us at ECU. We know you have questions. We're here to answer them.
I would highly recommend Eastman Credit Union for all your mortgage needs.
Just do it. Don't even think twice about it.
We love ECU.
And we think you will too.
I think our dogs would highly recommend ECU.
When you're driving a legend, nothing gets in your way, work or play. The tough built in the USA Tundra, the rugged Tacoma, and the ready for adventure 4Runner. For over 50 years, Toyota has built the best trucks money can buy. Trucks that legends are made of. Now, during Toyota Truck Month, get $1,000 cash back on a new 4Runner, $3,000 back on Tundra, with Toyota Care 2-year no-cost maintenance plan. Drive a legend. Toyota, let's go places.
The heart of your family. At Scott Britton Construction, we're honored to help make that dream a reality. Whether it's your first house, a home for your growing family, or your retirement dream, let us help you with your most important investment, we ensure every home is perfectly constructed from beginning to end. Quality craftsmanship and superior custom is our priority. Visit us at ScottBrittonConstruction.com for more.
It's track month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 19 Trax, $15,995. 19 Equinox, $20,995. 19 Blazer, $26,995. 20 Traverse, $29,995. 20 Tahoe, $42,995. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
And welcome back to the Musket Bowl. It's the fourth quarter, and the fans are dancing because we got a key second down. Boone on the drive, and we have a flag. Casey, normally this is the point of the game where you would see the Sky 5 drone in the air, but not tonight because of the rain, so our Sky 5 drone powered by Empire Ford has been grounded.
Yes, unfortunately, you know, this is the only game we've had weather being an issue, but yeah, they cannot fly the drone in the rain. Got some third quarter stats. David Crockett had 104 yards in the third quarter, 73 through the air, 31 on the ground. Daniel Boone, 78 yards, all of them on the ground. They believe the only pass they attempted in the third quarter was intercepted. Time of possession went in the favor of the Pioneers. They had the ball for 7 minutes, 13 seconds in the third quarter.
Worley in at quarterback now for Boone. They've played four people, actually, at the quarterback position tonight when they go to the Wildcat. I guess when it's the Wildcat, it's probably technically a tailback since they run some sort of single wing formation from that.
I think they may be waiting to reset the game clock to 12 minutes. Because they 2 seconds came off, but it was a false start, so that I had to reset, and that's what they did. They reset the
clock for 12 minutes. 12 minutes of action to decide who wins the Musket Bowl. Boone says, we're going to take a shot, and they'll give it to their star performer tonight. That's Blair going right up the middle.
And that 5-yard penalty, if not for that, that would have been a first down because he picks up 5 yards. So instead of a first down, it's now third and two for Daniel Boone. And Worley in the game there with Blair. I'd expect number one to get the ball here.
It would not be a huge surprise. Worley, of course, has done some damage as well. And Worley's going to keep it. He'll go off the left side as he tries for the first down. I believe he's got it.
Looks like he has it right on the marker.
It all depends on the spot. Yes.
They're going to give him the Toyota first down. All right, so the ball is at the Daniel Boone 45-yard line. We've played just over a minute here in the fourth quarter. Daniel Boone clinging to a 21-20 lead after David Crockett missed an extra point on their last touchdown that would have tied the game.
Another handoff. That's Blair up the middle, just blasting by everyone. Now outrunning the secondary. Can he be caught? No! Touchdown, Daniel Boone.
55 yards for Brennan Blair. And what's more than a hat trick, a 4-touchdown night for number one, Brennan Blair. That one goes 55 yards right up the middle.
Double B breaking free for the long touchdown. And racing right behind him was Colley, and Colley could not catch him. That tells you how fast he is.
A 55-yard touchdown run by Blair. Let's see if they can get the extra point to take an 8-point lead.
Jenkins is on. There's the kick, and as has been all night, right down the middle. Daniel Boone, 28. Crockett, 20. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
Welcome to Express Checkout. On FriendshipCars.com, you can view inventory from all our locations. Get the best pricing and choose your payment without the hassle. Get an instant cash offer for your trade-in. Research and select a protection package that works best for you. Take advantage of all Express Checkout has to offer and be in and out in under 30 minutes. That's it. It's that easy. Instant pricing and Express Checkout from FriendshipCars.com. Start your new car shopping experience today.
P.J. Johnson and Casey Getz live tonight from Gray, Tennessee. We're at the Musket Bowl. And, of course, when you play the Musket Bowl, you expect the unexpected. And it's 28-20 right now. Daniel Boone, the underdog in this game, with an 8-point lead. But we still have plenty of time left and a hungry Crockett team. Casey, how about that run?
Brennan Blair, 68 yards in that drive. It was four plays, 70 yards. Blair had 68 of those yards, just under 2 minutes off the clock. And again, that is four touchdowns for Brennan Blair.
Sounds to me like he wants to win one of your Player of the Week awards.
We have one more left to give out.
Another squib kick. Crockett fumbles around. Now they fall on it. Just falling on the ball has been a hard proposition tonight because of these wet conditions. First down for the Pioneers. You can see the rain coming down through the lights here in the stadium, and it really hasn't let up since we kicked off. That's about the time it started raining.
Yeah, I mean, during the pregame, we were here a little after 5 o'clock. It was not really raining, just sprinkling a little bit, but right around 7:30, it started coming down, and it has not stopped the entire game.
About the time Dave Dirks told me, don't worry about it. I think the downdraft or whatever.
And when he left is when it started raining.
And then he left and he let it rain, yeah. Dave always stays dry, if you notice. Well fed and dry.
All right, so David Crockett down by 8. So the only thing this changes would be if they would score a touchdown, obviously they would have to go for 2 rather than kick an extra point. So for now, it's too early to tell whether that missed extra point will have an impact on this game.
The poor cheerleaders tonight in ponchos, but they're right out there cheering in the rain, as you saw. Really good crowd tonight when you talk about the weather, but there's folks standing all along the fence, all the seats taken. Crockett with a great visitor's bench. That's Hackler on the little jet sweep on the right side. He'll get a couple.
If you're David Crockett with just over 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter, the way you're looking at it is realistically, you have to think you only have 2 more possessions likely in this fourth quarter.
Unless there's a turnover, you're probably right. And the way Boone has controlled the clock tonight, it's just tough to get the ball away from them. 3 wide receivers to the left, 2 to the right. Larkins and Joyner in the backfield. Larkins will throw it. He throws another high pass out of bounds over the head of Colley.
Yeah, well covered was Colley on that one. That was Austin Cunningham in coverage. Really good job there. There's nowhere for Larkins to throw the ball, so 3rd and 7. For David Crockett. They had a couple big third down conversions on their last. And we got the clock has been having some trouble here. It's running here after an incomplete pass. It's still running. As the rain continues to fall, the clock continues to run. They're going to have to probably put about 15, 20 seconds back on the clock. Actually, and they're going to add 35 seconds back on the clock to 9:31.
So while we have a break in the action here, time for us to take a break as well. You're watching Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
At At first glance, Toyota Highlander XLE makes a powerful statement. With a standard 3.5-liter V6 and the ability to take you anywhere you want to go. Inside, it's all about room and comfort, with spacious seating for 8 and 5 USB charging ports. Plus, Toyota Safety Sense, our most advanced safety features, are standard equipment. Now get $3,000 cash back on a built-in the USA Highlander, or get a low-mileage lease for just $249 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
It's a rainy night at the Musket Bowl, but what a night it's been for Daniel Boone High School. They hold a 28-20 lead right now, but David Crockett has the ball and a key third down.
Really big play right here on third down. I mean, if Daniel Boone gets the ball back the way their offense has been, I mean, David Crockett has not been able to stop their running game. They did have an interception they got in the third quarter, and I don't think Boone will be throwing another pass in this game unless they have to. You know, their run game has been that dominant, and David Crockett hasn't proven they can stop it. So David Crockett desperately needs this third down to continue the series. The delay is they're waiting for the official, the clock operating official who's on the field. He's coming up to the press box here to monitor the clock. We've had quite a lot of issues with the clock here tonight.
So now we have a clock operator in the press box, the official, so all is well, hopefully. And here we go. Third down from the shotgun. And we have a flag.
I think we had some movement by the Pioneers, so that's going to be a third and 12 now.
Of course, last week, Crockett lost to Tennessee High. We were behind in that ball.
They lost 28-21. Daniel Boone, meanwhile, they've won three in a row. They've been playing their best football of the season after a 1-4 start. They had a brutal non-conference schedule. They're playing their best football right now.
Larkin's waiting for the snap on third and long. Big rush by Boone. Larkin's evades it. He'll throw it up down the sidelines, and coming back for the ball is his receiver, and it's complete to Hackler, who tries to get across the field, and a great tackle there by Daniel Boone to save what could have been a huge play.
Yeah, Hackler might have actually lost a few yards, but he did get the first down. That's the most important part about that play. Really good jump by Larkins. He had some pressure up the middle. He rolls out to his right. Watch here, some pressure coming right up the middle. And Hackler does a good job of coming back to the football as well. You don't wait for the football to come, you come back to the football.
There's one thing about Larkins, you don't talk about him as a runner, but a lot of times, you know, he is able to evade that pressure with good footwork.
We got a trailblazer that was a little shaken up, Hagan Edwards, coming off after getting shaken up on the play. So we'll reset here. It's a first down for David Crockett as a big third down conversion. The ball is just inside the, it was about at the 44-yard line, 45-yard line, it looks like.
So it'll be first down for David Crockett. Larkins, quarterback draw, up the middle. He's going to be close to the first down. He's hit short. Short of the 45, spun around.
That play has been very effective tonight for David Crockett with the design quarterback run. They go five wide, spread it out. Larkins takes the snap, immediately tucks it and runs there, and he picks up 9 yards on first down.
That's a perfect example of why so many high school coaches love this spread offense that has different elements to it, because it gives you those running lanes as well as the short passing game.
They're sticking with that five receiver formation here.
Larkins waiting for the snap. Big rush over the middle. He throws it up. Incomplete, nearly intercepted.
Yeah, he is very lucky that one was not intercepted. Not sure who he was throwing that one to. I don't know if it sailed on Larkins or not, but there was not really a receiver.
Yeah, he had, I believe it was Colley down the right sidelines that was open, but he didn't see him. So that brings us to third and one.
Have not seen Ronquil Joyner, number one, back in the game. Remember when he asked out, looked like he was a little shaken up back in the third quarter. Have not seen him back in the game. So Brendan Reed, and to watch Larkins under center. He's going to snap it. That was a snap infraction. Yeah, that was, they were trying to go with a hurry up there, and they moved early.
Crucial penalty at the most terrible time of the night. 8 minutes, 18 seconds to go, and you jump on a hurry-up offensive play.
That's a dead giveaway when Larkins goes under center like that, that it's going to be a quarterback sneak. Daniel Boone saw it. They were bringing their guys up, and Crockett just moved a little bit too early. So now it's back to a third and six. Ball is at midfield.
Of course, you would have to imagine, even if they don't gain much here, they'll go for it on fourth down.
They got to call a timeout. David Crockett does, and Coach Chanley is really upset. The play clock was already running out. They would have had to cost him another 5 yards, so David Crockett uses a timeout.
You're watching Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, powered by your East Tennessee Toyota dealers.
Facebook Live game coverage is sponsored by Champion Chevrolet Cadillac in Johnson City.
Again, we appreciate all the folks watching on Facebook and, of course, the rest of you watching on Tri-City CW tonight. Terrific ball game here in the fourth quarter. It's 28-20 and a huge third down facing the David Crockett Pioneers. From the shotgun, Larkins drills it, and he's got his receiver complete for the first down. That's Hackler.
Tell you what, when David Crockett needs a big play, they go to Dante Hackler. He's had a couple of really nice catches tonight. They get a Toyota first down. They move the sticks.
You know, for most teams in this area, when you have a third and one, then it goes to third and six, you're like, oh, boy, it's trouble. But for David Crockett, it's just another play because they can throw the ball so well. Larkin's trying to march his team down the field. They trail by eight. Plenty of time left. Larkin straight drop back. Over the middle. He's got his receiver. That's Hackler. And he'll have another first down. The crossing pattern works again.
Hackler, awfully tough to cover when you're going across the length of the field like that. Brennan Blair trying his best to stay with Hackler. You see him. Hackler started at the right side, comes across to the left, and you just all those pick plays here. Devon White trying to chase him down as well. And a linebacker has no chance to stay with Hackler.
No, he can run east and west as well as anyone. Larkins watching his team march down the field. Another drop back, big rush. That ball was batted down at the line of scrimmage. It's incomplete.
Yeah, they were looking for Hackler on the wide receiver screen, but Cole Bishop gets a tip there. And I tell you what I say there is Daniel Boone, they are blitzing up the middle there. They're bringing pressure right up the middle.
Don't forget about our Toyota Drive of the Game. We'll be announcing that. The Toyota Drive of the Game coming up very shortly, actually, as we're in the fourth quarter play. Larkins like to add to his numbers tonight and get his team in the end zone. He's got a big rush. Somehow he escapes. Now the defense runs him down, and Larkins is sacked. Great play by the Daniel Boone defense there.
That's Will Hamlin.
He ran him down, Casey. Look at this replay from Toyota. He dances with his feet. He's okay right there. But when he starts going east and west, he's just pulled down from behind like a rodeo cowboy.
What a play there for Daniel Boone's defense. Third and 22 now for David Crockett.
I don't know how many times we can keep saying this is the play of the game, but it probably will be. And there's been some movement. Another penalty, it looks like, on Crockett.
So third and 27. Delay a game. That's the second time they've had a delay a game tonight. So now it's a third and 27. The ball is at the 40. They need to get inside the 15.
Three receivers to the left. Larkins drops back. Big rush. He's going to throw it down the right side. He's got a receiver, but it's going to be picked off. Here comes Boone back the other way. That's Jones. Jones still on his feet, and he's tackled at about the 50-yard line. What a play by this Boone defense.
Joe Jones with the big-time interception there for Daniel Boone. Larkins was going for the end zone. And Joe Jones comes up with the interception. That ball might have been a little bit underthrown. In these conditions, though, you have to expect that. Looked like maybe the ball almost was slipping a little bit out of Larkin's hands there. Joe Jones returns that all the way to the 49-yard line.
Having said that, he threw it into double coverage, though. It did have the three receivers to the left. He thought he had single coverage, but it was actually double coverage. So now, Boone, you expect their ground game just to eat this clock up. Here's been the star of the show. Number one, Double B. It's a huge gain of another 5-6 yards on first down.
Daniel Boone up by 8. Under 6 minutes left in the game. Each team has 2 timeouts left. Brennan Blair.
He's been the workhorse tonight.
All 4 touchdowns for Daniel Boone.
This could make Daniel Boone's season. The season has been plagued by injuries and bad luck. They could reverse it all tonight. 5 more minutes. Can they hang on? That's the question facing this Boone team. Wildcat play. White takes a handoff from Blair.
He does a good job to get back to the line of scrimmage. Does White, so that's now 3rd and 5. David Crockett's defense, they need to stop right here. The clock under 5 minutes. You had a 40-second play clock, and you could take an awful lot of time off.
It's like the Daniel Boone offense, the coaches are screaming at the offense, like, what are you guys doing? He's wanting to call a timeout. Jeremy Jenkins does just that.
Hey, Coach Jenkins calling a timeout, realizing, I think, how important this play is here. They could get a first down. They would be able to eat another 2 or 3 minutes off the clock, and David Crockett have to start using their timeouts if they pick up this first down. If Boone does not get this first down, depending on how many yards they pick up, they potentially have to punt the ball back to David Crockett.
Well, it's clearly that Jeremy Jenkins saw something because he ran all the way down the sidelines to call timeout. Like, he did not like either the defensive formation that Crockett presented or what his kids were going to do on offense.
Yeah, I think this is just where he wants to make sure any play he's been saving or their go-to play, this is the time you want to run in here. I think he wants to make sure everyone's on the same page, realizing and stressing to his guys how important this play is here on 3rd and 5. And honestly, if they pick up a couple yards here, I would expect them to go for it on 4th down, the way they've been running the ball. Here are the smartest fans of the game bringing the tent.
They certainly are. I'm not sure where that is. Must be out on our left of us, the press box. So here we go. Oh, and Boone has jumped off sides. Looked like the right tackle.
Yeah, false start. That's a big penalty. Now it's 3rd and 10.
for a running team.
Yeah. I mean, the last pass they attempted was intercepted. So despite it being third and 10, I expect them to keep the ball on the ground here.
Jenkins has been the passing quarterback mostly tonight.
I'm not throwing a pass up by eight here and risking that. I'm going to make David Crockett stop me in the run game here. You got Devon White in the backfield.
It's the Wildcat. Blair. Blair keeps it. He's going to be running left and cutting back right. He'll get three or four, way short of that first down.
And David Crockett's calling timeout. That's the second timeout for the Pioneers. Hayden Chanley trying to preserve as much of that clock as possible. 4:05 left in the fourth quarter.
That penalty turned out to be huge. Don't forget, you can watch all your highlights on WCYB tonight, Friday Night Huddle.
Catch the biggest plays and the final scores on Friday Night Huddle with News 5 Sports and Williams every Friday night during Fox 39 News at 10. Friday Night Huddle is sponsored by Ingalls and Nice Wonder Children's Hospital.
Heather will have all the scores and highlights later tonight while we're soaking here in the rain.
Only on WCYB. No 10 o'clock news tonight on Fox 39 because of the World Series.
That is correct.
All right, so fourth and six. David Crockett calling that timeout here. They actually added 4 seconds back on the clock. 4:09 here again, fourth and six. If you're David Crockett, you cannot jump here. And if it made it a fourth and one, Boone might be tempted to go for it.
They decided to punt it, it looks like.
Oh, yeah, you have to punt it here on fourth and six.
Hackler. High snap, but the punt is away.
Hackler's not even going to fool with it.
No, and it's going to take a great roll. If Crockett's going to win this game, they're going to have to go about 80 yards, maybe more.
Yeah, ball's going right at the 15-yard line. So they go 85 yards.
And 4 minutes.
And with only one timeout left in high school football, this is their last chance here. I mean, if they don't score here, Boone will be able to run the clock out with only one timeout for David Crockett left to stop it here. So this is the last possession likely for the Pioneers, their last chance to score here. Got to go 85 yards, one timeout. But I think if you ask Hayden Chanley, he wouldn't want anyone else directing this offense in this position other than Cade Larkins.
Larkins has been down this road before, of course. Not been super sharp tonight, thrown a couple of interceptions. But now he's trying to lead his team back. He's got Hackler out in the flat. Hackler breaks a tackle. He'll pick up another 8 yards, it looks like, on first down.
It's really imperative on this drive for the offensive line because unless it's a short yard situation, the running game is not going to be happening for David Crockett. They're not going to be running the ball anymore other than to maybe pick up a first down here or there.
Clock continues to tick away those seconds. Larkins looking over here. Throws it over the head of Colley.
Went off Colley's hands, and Daniel Lusk almost able to come down with that one. We got a Daniel Boone player.
That looks like Blair on the ground. May have turned his ankle. Blair's been all over the field tonight.
I mentioned that running the ball would not be something you're going to do here very often unless it was to get a first down. I think this is the time maybe you're going to do that on third and one. The most important thing for David Crockett is getting that first down and a new set of downs as Blair comes off the field. Third and one in. It looks like Ronquil Joyner is back in the game for David Crockett. First time we've seen him in quite a while.
Joyner left with what appeared to be a knee injury. Now he's back. Larkins fumbling that ball and running off the right side, and he'll dive for the first down.
Well, he's very lucky that ball, he did not drop that ball. Larkins picks up the Toyota first down, and they can move the sticks.
Clock continues to tick. We're almost down to 3 minutes.
This drive started at 4 minutes left, so they've taken almost a minute off the clock, and they've gotten 11 yards.
They've got to get a lot more than that if they plan to win. Larkin's under a big rush, tries to fight it off, and he's got a man open. He lobs it up, and it's almost intercepted. Almost. That was so dangerous.
Boy, and Larkins was really close to almost going past the line of scrimmage on that one when he let that go. Daniel Boone is bringing the pressure.
Great job by Larkins to escape the tackle and just loft it up. But Rucker, John Rucker, number 8, could not come down with it. So here he was, 2nd and long.
You know, Colley has not been targeted in a while here. See if 21 is on the receiving end of this attempt.
High snap. Larkins throws it back, and look at it. It is Colley. He breaks a tackle.
That was Hackler.
It was Hackler. My bad.
Another big third down. Need that first down, does David Crockett. 2.5 minutes left.
Larkin's waiting for the snap. Another big rush. He steps up and he throws it over the middle. Incomplete. That was to Colley.
Almost looked like he was trying to hand that off and almost aiming that a little too much on that one to Larkins. And here is, we can say, the play of the game. If they don't get this first down, it's over.
David Crockett trying to win the Musket Bowl for the 2nd year in a row. They need a great play. The clock is ticking down to 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 1 second. High snap. Larkins somehow came down with it and gets the first down.
What a run by Larkins.
That was so close to the clock expiring there, Casey.
I'd like to see if we can sync that up. I don't know, but it was really close to being a delay of game. But he dropped the ball. It bounced right back to him.
He just got a lucky bounce on that, but what a great athletic play. They may have saved him on that one play.
They're close to midfield now as we're under 2 minutes to go.
Back to live actions. That's Larkins in the pocket over the middle. He's got his man. That's Hackler. He's got a couple of guys to beat. He spins down to the 40.
Looks like he has a first down. The clock will stop momentarily.
Minute 48.
That is a first down.
Remember, when they mark this ball, though, it'll start again.
Toyota first down for the Pioneers. The ball's at the 41-yard line of Daniel Boone.
Another thrilling game on Friday Night Rivals. Larkin, sidearm throw. He's got his man down to the 30. The march continues.
We've had some high snaps the last couple of times as well. Prince Colley with the catcher. That's something to keep an eye on, though. Larkins is using all of his 6'3" frame to these high snaps. Ball's down to the 30-yard line as another first down. Now we got a timeout by Daniel Boone.
Woo! Minute 27, Casey. Daniel Boone calls timeout.
That is their final timeout of the game. Jeremy Jenkins maybe wanted to reset his defense after they've given up 2 back-to-back first down pass plays. Here are the last 3 plays of the game. Here's the 4th down, the high snap, the bounce up to Larkins.
What a perfect bounce.
He picks up the first down, and then he goes to the air on the next play. This one to Hackler for a first down into Daniel Boone territory. Then the very next play, another high snap. He finds Colley for another first down. So the ball is at the 30-yard line of Daniel Boone. A minute 27 to go. David Crockett has 1 timeout left. Daniel Boone, no timeouts left.
Larkin has to be approaching, I would think, over 250 yards passing tonight. He would like nothing better than to add 30 more to that total.
He's at 306 right now.
306, okay. Larkin steps up. He's got some running room, but he's going to throw it up high. And that ball is batted down by the Boone defense.
That was Joe Jones. What a play there by Joe Jones, knocking that one away. Hey, Larkins maybe could have run that for a few yards there, but he went for the end zone, and Joe Jones knocks that, actually hit his shoulder pad.
Oh, yeah. Jones going skyward to knock that away. Who needs arms? Use my shoulder pad.
A minute 19 left. If you're David Crockett, you don't need to go all 30 yards here on one play.
Second down. Larkins, he's going to run it up the middle. Now cutting back to the left, trying to find that sideline.
Did he get out of bounds? He did not get out of bounds. That clock.
That clock's going to run down.
Gonna run.
Crockett needs to hurry. They're kind of lollygagging around here. The clock is their enemy.
Third and three as we're under a minute to go. Ball's at the 23.
Larkin's rolling right. He's got plenty of time. He's going to throw it up and out of bounds. Incomplete.
All right, so we got another fourth down, a fourth and three. David Crockett here. Maybe you want to call a timeout, make sure everyone's settled here. You got a timeout left. If you want to talk things over, now would be a time to do it here. Fourth and three, got to have it.
Colley looks like he's limping a little. These kids have to be tired. Very physical ball game tonight. The Boone cheerleaders doing their thing in the rain. Can Cade Larkins pull off a miracle? Larkins going over the middle. It's complete. That's Hackler. Hackler fighting for every yard.
Great job by Larkins. Boone brought a blitz right up the middle. Larkins throws it over to Hackler. They get a first down. Clock stops. 35 seconds left. When that ball gets spotted, that clock's going to wind.
Larkins has to get ready to take the snap. Looks like Crockett's in place. We're in the Toyota red zone. That's Larkins trying to evade tacklers, but the clock is ticking as he's wasted a lot of time. We're down at 20 seconds.
They got to call a timeout, and they do. That was not a good decision by Cade Larkins to run the ball there.
It was worth the yardage because he ate up 10 seconds on the clock. We've got 19 seconds to play now, and Larkins is exhausted.
That's the final timeout for David Crockett. The ball was at the, looks like at the 15-yard line.
Olivia, what can you tell us from the sidelines?
Yeah, PJ, Casey, it's just electric down here. Now, they're all fighting for this Toyota Friday Night's Rivals Trophy, but they're also fighting for that musket. This is the Musket Bowl. This is a super competitive game between these two Washington County, Tennessee teams. It's tradition. You can hear it rocking in here, and even though the rain is still falling, this game is so close, no one has even left the stadium.
Well, you're right about that, Olivia. Everybody's still here, and everybody's still wet, except for us.
All right, so the ball is at the 15-yard line. It's second down. They need to get to, looks like, the 8-yard line for a first down. They cannot throw anything short of the first down marker. With 19 seconds left, the clock could run out, so they're going to have to go to the end zone or throw some out patterns to get a first down. You could also throw it over the middle, but you have to be past the first down marker so the clock will stop.
So do you think he has a play for this?
With 19 seconds, as long as you throw it past the 8-yard line, you can throw it anywhere in the field. I would expect some crossing routes coming across. You've got three receivers up to the far side.
Larkins has had a big rush placed against him. What can he do? Another big rush. He's got time. He's got a man open in the corner. It's a high throw, and it's knocked down. It's knocked down by Daniel Boone. He just put a little too much air under that one.
That was Daniel Lusk. They were throwing a jump ball to Mason Britton. Mason Britton is 6'4", and Daniel Lusk is 5'11", but you couldn't tell it on that play here as Lusk goes up there and knocks that down. So it's third down, 12 seconds left. Again, they cannot throw short of the first down marker here. Have to go for the end zone here.
And again, they have to throw it, can't run it. Clock will run out.
And he can't run around too much or the whole clock could run out.
Larkins sets, plenty of time, waits, throws it up high, and it's incomplete.
That was Lusk again, looking for Mitten, Britton again.
Well, what was the marker?
Somebody has a helmet off on Daniel Boone. Look at the replay here. And again, it's a jump ball. And
oh, so close.
Britton can't come down with it.
So they've tried two lob plays to Britton back to back.
I think the penalty.
Will it be against Boone because they lost the helmet?
Well, in the way Coach Jenkins, they're talking to Coach Jenkins here. I never saw a call on what it was here. Here we go.
Oh, it is against Boone. Is it unsportsmanlike conduct?
Illegal participation.
Illegal participation, okay.
So that's half the distance to the goal. They're going to measure for a first down here. That really doesn't matter with only 5 seconds left.
It's one play.
One play.
We're down to one play.
Fourth and one or first and goal.
It's the Musket Bowl. It's down to one play. Do we expect anything else?
I mean, if it is first down, you could potentially get two plays off, but that clock, you know, it'd be risky. And they're going to measure here to see if it's a first and goal or fourth and short. But it should come down to just one final play. Looks like
short.
It is short. So it's fourth down, but that really is not of major consequence here. It's 5 seconds, the one chance to throw the ball here in the end zone, barring a defensive penalty.
Well, game as advertised.
The last two throws have gone to Mason Britton. I would be surprised if Hackler or Cauley not on the receiving end of this play.
Will it come down to one play? 8 points down.
Hackler and Cauley are both in the slots on each side of the field.
Larkins waiting for the snap. Big rush over the middle. It's deflected. It's deflected. It's incomplete. But there is a second left on the clock.
1.4.
Well, for sure, this is
one more play.
The last play, at least in the regular time. If they score, there'll be a chance for two. But, wow, it's all going to come down to this.
So that play was going to Cauley right there, thrown a little bit high. And he's 7 yards, does David Crockett here.
Tired bunch of kids on the field. Got to tip your hats to both these teams. What an electric performance tonight. And it all comes down to this. Larkins fakes the handoff. Now it's a double
pass.
He's
going to throw it.
Back to Larkins. Larkins has it. He's tackled. So Crockett runs a trick play. And Daniel Boone has won the Musket Bowl.
Wow,
what a call.
They go with a wide receiver pass on fourth down, and Larkins, he caught it, but Daniel Boone was ready for it.
Unbelievable. A gutsy call. We've got it here on the Toyota replay. Keep your eye on the ball.
Prince Cauley hands it off to Hackler. Hackler throws it to Kay Larkins. There's one man keeping him out of the end zone. I think that was Lusk. Daniel Lusk, I think, number 13 for Daniel Boone, was the one who made the tackle.
Isn't that the play they ran in the Super Bowl to Nick Foles, the Philly special?
Yeah, Philly special.
It wasn't so special this time, though, as Daniel Boone said, hey, I saw the Super Bowl.
I believe in the Super Bowl, I think that was on like the 2 or 3 yard line. That was from the 7 yard line here. But check out our Toyota drive of the game. It's Daniel Boone wins the Musket Bowl 28-20. This is Blair, his fourth and final touchdown of the game. He had a 8 yard run here, and then a first down by Worley. And then the big play on this drive was 55 yards for Blair. And that made it 28-20.
And they are celebrating with the Musket, and they're going to celebrate with another trophy as well, Casey.
Yeah, they got the Musket right now, and then we'll be giving them the Friday Night Rivals trophy. And how about this? We had a couple teams We'll talk about that when we come back.
Yep, you're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals, presented by your East Tennessee Toyota dealer.
Kids' lab results can look funny.
But with 25 pediatric specialties, we know what's normal for kids and what's not. This, by the way, is normal. We're Nyswanger Children's Hospital.
At this time in your life, would you like a little extra attention when you feel you need it? Hi, I'm Alina Haynes. At Colonial Hill Retirement Center, we have supportive services to provide the extra attention you deserve. Keep yourself healthy and fit in our exercise classes. Need medication reminders? We can do that. Need a little help to look your best? We can do that. Our friendly staff will help keep you at your very best. Call 282-6903 or just drop by.
It's tailgating season. Make yours a big hit with any of these favorites from Food City.
Like Deli Fresh Fried Chicken, made in-store salads, and more only at Food City.
Value every day, Food City.
At Food City, fresh means our beef is ground in the store several times a day. Time-stamped with the hour it was ground. Just one of the many reasons we say, start fresh with Food City.
At 10, your exclusive home of the Fox 39 10-day forecast, so you can plan ahead. Chief Meteorologist Dave Dirks brings you the first forecast of the night with weather information to help keep you and your family safe. Ricky Matthews goes beyond the maps with Weather Why to answer questions on how weather happens. During severe weather, Dave will be issuing weather alerts so you can plan ahead for the next big weather maker. Get your last forecast of the night first on Fox 39 News at 10.
Kids have faster heart and respiratory rates.
So we have specialists who only treat kids. Pediatricians who know when everything's running normally and when it's sped up. We're Nyswanger Children's Hospital.
They are going to be talking about this Musket Bowl for a lot of years. 28-20 goes down to the final play of the game. A double reverse pass stopped by the Daniel Boone defense. The musket has been presented. Now it's time to present the Friday Night Rivals trophy. Here's Olivia Bailey.
See the excitement at all up there from the press box. But Coach Jenkins, you all battled the elements here tonight. You battled a tough Crockett team. Talk a little bit about your keys to success in this game.
Well, you know, we talked before the game that being a four-quarter game and being the tougher team and the more physical team on the field. And I thought for four quarters, our kids were the toughest team and really played physical all night. And you know, what a great game for our conference and this county. But what about them Blazers?
Says it all. The celebration continues at Daniel Boone. We'll be back with a final wrap-up right after this.
It's track month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 19 tracks, $15,995. 19 Equinox, $20,995. 19 Blazer, $26,995. 20 Traverse, $29,995. 20 Tahoe, $42,995. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
It's tailgating season. Make yours a big hit with any of these favorites from Food City.
Like Deli Fresh Fried Chicken, made in-store salads, and more only at Food City.
Value every day, Food City.
At Food City, fresh means our beef is ground in the store several times a day. Time-stamped with the hour it was ground. Just one of the many reasons we say, start fresh with Food City.
At ECU, we've got a mortgage product that fits your needs.
As first-time homebuyers, there are so many different options. It was really kind of intimidating.
But ECU made it easy. They helped us through every step.
Whether you're buying your first home or your forever home, come see us at ECU. We know you have questions. We're here to answer them.
I would highly recommend Eastman Credit Union for all your mortgage needs.
Just do it. Don't even think twice about it.
We love ECU.
And we think you will, too.
I think our dogs would highly recommend ECU.
When the sun comes up, it's go time, whether at work or at play, on the field or off. Life doesn't stop, and neither should you. So when you get injured, Holston Medical Group is here to get you back on your feet. Our orthopedic and sports medicine physicians deliver quality care that exceeds expectations, specializing in non-surgical techniques and minimally invasive procedures to get you back in the game fast. Now with convenient walk-in access in Bristol at Sapling Grove, we are HMG, your doctor, your family, your health partner for life.
At Colonial Hill Retirement Center, you'll have all the comforts of home. Hi, I'm Alina Haynes. Colonial Hill Retirement Center has a 24-hour staff, an elegant full-service dining room, and housekeeping to keep things neat and clean. Don't worry about repairs and maintenance. Our staff will take care of everything. Like to entertain with family and friends? We can help you with that. You just relax and enjoy life. Call 282-6903 or just drop by.
It's Truck Month at Champion Chevrolet on the Motor Mile in Johnson City. 19 Crew Cab All-Star, $11,000 off. 19 Extended Cab All-Star, $12,000 off. 19 Light Duty Extended Cab, $12,000 off. 19 2500 Duramax Diesel, $13,771 off. Champion Chevrolet, how do they do that?
And welcome back to Daniel Boone High School. The final again, Daniel Boone wins the Musket Bowl 28-20. And Casey, it was a game for the ages. It really was.
Yeah, Brennan Blair, the running back for Daniel Boone, 196 yards, four touchdowns on the losing effort. Kay Larkins threw for 311 yards. And how about this? Daniel Boone wins the Musket Bowl without Charlie Cole.
Wow.
If they can get, they're going to be in the playoffs. If they could get him back in the playoffs, this Daniel Boone team could be very, very dangerous, BJ.
They certainly could. Well, tonight was our final telecast of the season for Friday Night Rivals. You know, I'm extremely proud of the work we have done here because it's taken a small army to pull this off. Tom Cupp, our chief engineer, and his entire staff, we have to thank you. I know you put in 14-hour days, and we appreciate it. Our drone pilots, Ricky Matthews and Keith Roberts, gave us a view like no other. Unfortunately, we couldn't do that tonight. Each week, we work with a new crew that we hired out, but there were always two constants. That was Matt and Mark. You're both true professionals, and we really appreciate you. We hope we meet you again somewhere down the road. It is personally gratifying for me to do something that so many people said could not be done in this market, televised high school football. Even people in our own building said we couldn't do it. We proved them all wrong tonight with a compelling and exciting product. It takes money and lots of money to do what we do. That's why we love our sponsors so much, many of whom have become personal friends. Toyota, Hosta Medical Group, FriendshipCars.com, Champion Chevrolet, Food City, and Northeast State Community College. Most of all, though, I would like to thank the man next to me. This is Casey Getz. Ideas are great, but it's execution that counts. Casey did all the hard work here. He started back in February to put this schedule together. He talked to athletic directors, coaches. He had to negotiate with sponsors. He did everything it took to pull all this together with very little thanks, and he doesn't do it for very much of all except for the love of these kids in this area that play high school sports. He's devoted to them, and we thought it was our chance to showcase those kids. If you liked our work this season, please let us know on Facebook or drop our general manager, Steve Flint, a note. I'm sure he would love the feedback. As for next year and our telecast, well, stay tuned. We leave you tonight with some final images of the Musket Bowl. For Casey Getz.
And for PJ. He did a heck of a job as well. I'm not going to let him forget it here. Yeah, hey. I just want to thank you for everybody, too. But, yeah, PJ did a heck of a job as well.
Hey, I'm an old dog learning a new trick. For Casey Getz, this is PJ Johnson. So long from Daniel Boone High School. We'll leave you tonight with some final images from one great Musket Bowl.